coming in the air tonight. Oh Lord, I've been waiting for this moment all my life. Oh Lord, can you feel it coming in the air tonight? Oh Lord, oh
good morning, Matt.
Well, if you told me you were drowning, I would not lend a hand. I've seen your face before, my friend, but I don't know if you know who I am. Well, I was there and I saw what you did. I saw it with my own two eyes. So you can wipe off that grin. I know where you've been. It's all been a
good morning, Battle Angel. Good morning, Colby. Good morning, NC's Gone Fishing. Yeah, it's already midday, just earlier.
The last time we ever met. But I know the reason why you kept your silence up. No, you don't fool me. Well, the hurt doesn't show, but the pain still grows. It's no stranger to you and me.
Hey, Luke, I can think of a lot weirder things than that. In fact, so weird that I can't even say them. Hey, you might want to go to the doctor for that, bro. I'm just saying. This is where we all came from. In my mind, in my head, this is where we all came from. Hey, Colby, you know the rule, right? You're supposed to spend 2 months' salary on an engagement ring. Now, I don't know how much you make. But it's a lot, you know. I mean, what you're going to spend on that ring's a lot. Oh, yeah, dude, the engagement ring costs four times the amount as the wedding band does. At least.
In my mind, in my head, this is where we all came from. The dreams we had, the love we shared, this is what we're waiting for. This is where we all came from. In my mind, in my
Good morning, Jeremy. Good morning, Alex. Hoghead, you ask why. I say, why not?
Drink some margaritas by a string of blue lights. Listen to the mariachi play at midnight. Are you with me? Are you with me?
This is the worst song I've ever heard in my life. It's official. You know. It's like a train wreck. You know, I want to turn it off because it's so terrible, but I can't stop listening. Maybe the real version is probably not so terrible, but whatever they've done to this thing, they've made it terrible. I don't know. I've never heard the real one, though. Do I have a bookie? Well, having a bookie would be illegal, Colby. So, officially, no, I don't. No. Mm-mm. I guess Slim Shady could be my bookie because he lives in Tennessee, so he can legally bet. So I guess I could always have him be my my in-between guy. You know what I mean? I know a guy.
Drink some margaritas by a string of blue lights. Listen to the mariachi play at midnight.
This fucking song's gonna be stuck in my head all day now.
Are you with me? I wanna dance by the water underneath the Mexican sky.
He did make a video about Tennessee basketball. He posted it last night. Let's see if I can find that. I'm sure that I can. Let's see here, Uncle Lou. You want to see it? It's very short. Here, we'll watch it together. It's a watch party. How about that?
Get cable-free live TV with no hidden fees or long-term contracts.
Fair use in that.
Yep, good morning in that. Sorry for the car video. Lou Jr. soccer practice is getting ready to wrap up here, getting ready to take him home. Just a couple of quick things.
A couple of quick things about this video. I'm not against car videos. I've done several of them, actually. Maybe even dozens, if you're counting. Why is the camera so close to his face? I mean, I know he's in a Mustang, so there's not a lot of room in there. But you can basically see up this man's nose. You can count his nose hairs, bro.
In this video. First of all, Tennessee sucks at everything. I really don't know if they're good at anything at all. They've never even made a Final Four in basketball, never mind won a Natty. Georgia's made a Final Four in basketball, not Tennessee. They've never won a baseball championship ever. Georgia has. And, of course, football, they haven't even won their division in 16 years. Haven't won the conference in 25 years. Haven't won a national title since last century. They're just an irrelevant football program who pretty much sucks at everything. The other thing is, no call-in show tonight. I'm just wore. I've been running nonstop since 7:30 this morning. I'm not going to bore you with the details, but I've just been running nonstop. So no call-in show tonight, and I don't even know if I'll do the morning show in the morning. I don't know. May take a three-day weekend by not doing the morning show tomorrow.
This video is the reason I'm on the air right now.
And no call-in show tonight. Have a good morning.
Yeah. I saw an Uncle Lou video come up on my notifications.
I know it's the day of the off.
Last night, I watched it. I heard that he wasn't going to be doing a morning show today. I texted Uncle Lou. I said, is the rumor true? Are you not doing a morning show tomorrow? He said, no. I said, okay, well, then I am. So here we are. It's funny how things work, isn't it? Yeah, I don't procrastinate or procrastinate. You know what I mean? My mom taught me at a very young age. She said, don't put off tomorrow what you can do today. Now, technically, the midday would still be today. But you get what I mean. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Midday Show. It's the same show, just earlier. I mean, I don't know what else to tell you. Just earlier. What are you guys doing this weekend? Guess what I'm doing today? Later today. You guys should be very, very jealous. You will be jealous once I tell you what I'm doing. I'm going to meet up with our boy, Scott Kerr. Yeah. It's been at least 3 weeks since I've seen Scott. So, yeah, I'm going to meet him for a beer at happy hour later this afternoon. So, I'll give you a full report on Scott Kerr on the call-in show tonight. Yeah, tonight at 10 p.m. Yeah, now the call-in show will be at 10 p.m. It won't be early. It won't be the same call-in show just earlier. It'll be the same call-in show at the same call-in show time that I normally do. That's right. What I have planned for you this morning, again, it's the same show just earlier. So what we'll do today is we'll read the news. And we'll bring some people on the StreamYard. And maybe, I had an idea. Every once in a while, I get comments that pop up from videos that are years old. It's always weird when that happens. I don't know. I can't figure out the YouTube algorithm. You know what I mean? I don't know if people find my channel and just go down to, you know, start looking, like scrolling through and going back and looking at old videos. But every once in a while, I'll get a comment on a video that's like 2 or 3 years old. So that gave me an idea this morning, because I got a comment yesterday, I think, on a video that was like 3 years old. And the funny thing is, whenever they comment on a video that's 3 years old, they always act like I just made it. Like, you know, if I make a video making fun of school, about a loss or something, then they comment on like the game happened yesterday or something, which is weird. But anyway, gave me an idea. I know a lot of you guys are new here. When I say new, I mean you haven't been around for the entire 5.5 years that I've been doing this. But does anybody have any requests from an old Pigskin Peete video? Now, I hesitate to do this because I hate watching my old videos. Well, I hate watching any of my videos, but I especially hate watching my old videos. Some of them are beyond silly. But I will take a request. Anybody has a favorite old video that I did, let me know, and we can watch it. Or I'll let you watch it, and I'll step away for a second. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'll do. But there you have it. There you have it. Oh, shit. Wrong button. What am I doing? Let's see who's in the chat here real quick, and then we'll get to the show. Luke has one, paternity test. Now, there's two paternity tests. You talking about the one where I actually sent off for the paternity test? The first one? The Ohio State one? There's a paternity test one, and then there's a child support one. both of which are some of my most popular videos on YouTube. What do you mean what's up with this? Hold on now. Slim. Bro. Where's it at? What's wrong with my shirt? Come on, man. It's called style, bro. That's what it's called. Come on now. It's springtime. Don't be hating. Y'all don't like this shirt? Is Slim the only one that doesn't like this shirt? Shirt's banging, bro. What's up, Matt? NC Gone Fishing Battle Angel is here. Good morning, Battle Angel. Colby. Macklin Griffin. Luke. Slim Shady Canes. It burns when I pee 69. I believe that it burns when I pee is Miyagi Fang Karate. Actually, I know it is because I can see his picture. But if it does burn when you pee, you might want to get that checked out. I'm just saying, I'm not a doctor, but I do play one on TV. What's up, Jeremy Gerritsen? Alex the Mid. Hoghead, JW13120, JW1230. I would like to know the meaning behind this man's name. And I'm assuming it's a man. I shouldn't be assuming that, should I? It's 2023. I don't know. It could be anybody. I mean, there's no indication or picture. It could be a woman. I don't know. But I would like to know the meaning behind. I'm assuming JW is probably his or hers initials, like Jack White. Okay. I don't know what it is. Justin Wilcock. You know, I don't know. But I would like to know what the 13120 and the 1230 is. Because he didn't just pick that randomly. Those numbers mean something to this man or woman. I know it. But I just don't know what it is. It's a riddle. It's a riddle. What's up, Brad Pitt? Wet blanket. Dog behind enemy lines. Early midday show. It's the same show, just earlier. That's right. Stingray's here. Good morning to you too, sir. Click and bait, dude. The video that you made in your garage after the 2018 national championship win. Oh, wow. Wow. Yeah, your boy was heated, wasn't he? You would think after winning a national championship in 2018 that I would be mad. I mean, that I would be happy. But the vibe in that video was more anger than happiness, wasn't it? It's weird. Another one that I made in my garage. I think I've only made two garage videos on YouTube. I'll go ahead and tell you this. Anytime I'm making a video in my garage, there's a reason for it. It's because it's the last option. I can't do it in the house because there's, you know, kids running around or my wife. I can't do it outside because there's people outside or dogs barking. So, you know, anything short of locking myself in a bathroom. I've even done that. I have actually done a video where I sat on the shitter. Now, I wasn't shitting or anything like that, but I had to lock myself inside of a bathroom to make a video. It was that important. But I did one in my garage where I pretended to, this is great. I pretended to be a Georgia fan. And the comment section in that video, the comments on it, the amount of people, and I was wearing a Clemson hat. That's the funniest part. The comments on that video, the amount of people that just came across that video who didn't know me, who weren't subscribers, that actually thought I was being serious, was alarming. One guy was like, why does this Georgia fan have a Clemson hat on? I'm like, well, gee, I wonder why. Fucking idiot. TriStar is here. He says, hashtag mimic the gimmick. Bulldog JC, Sports Talk 101. Twisted Rooster. Hey, announcement. Hold on. Give me a second here. breaking news from the Pigskin Peete YouTube channel.
Yes,
I will be joining Rooster Man, Twisted Rooster, on the Twisted Rooster YouTube channel next Thursday at 7 p.m. I believe that's what we said, isn't it? I'll have to go back and check my text. I believe next Thursday at 7 p.m. I'll be on the Twisted Rooster channel. So mark it down. And if you haven't subscribed to the Rooster Man, do so now, please. And thank you. Joey Foster. Good morning, sir. Money Man. JW13120, JW1230 says he is a man indeed, and also that he did make that name up. So there is no meaning to it. Okay. All right. Well, that's good to know. What's up, Fence Company guy? Rack Dog. Sven Kruseberg. The Nature Boy. All right, all right, all right. I keep getting older, and they stay the same age. You got a joint, man? You'd be a lot cooler if you did. All right, what was the request again? The paternity test video. I need to refill my coffee anyway. I'll put on the paternity test. Give me a second to find it, all right? I'm not cool like a lot of these other YouTubers who have two monitors. I've got one monitor. So it takes me longer to do shit. You know what I'm saying? Give me a second. I don't even know how to find this. What year was that? Was that 2019? Well, I'll just type in Pigskin Peete paternity test, see if it comes up. There it is. 3 years ago. This is, oh man, this is something here. This was before the Fiesta Bowl. And of course, Clemson did win that game. We already know that.
Backdoor problems? Preparation A.
Why is this guy, Pigskin Peete, always running ads on his videos? I don't know what's wrong with this guy. All right, here. Enjoy.
Alright, go to the mailbox, be right back.
What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Pigskin Peete. So after a lot of speculation, I've been trying to tell all these Ohio State fans that Clemson's their daddy and I'm their daddy, and a lot of them are arguing with me. So I'm doing the right thing here. I sent off for a DNA paternity test last week, after I got a lot of backlash about the whole Clemson is your daddy thing. So I'm on the way to the mailbox right now to get...
I'm disappointed in my viewers for not pointing out how terrible those glasses were. What? I don't even know where... I don't even remember having those glasses. Those look like my kids. They must have been my kids. I've got a small head, and they look small on my face.
Get the results of this paternity test. They said it would be here today. And so I'm hoping it is. So I'm going to the mailbox now. We'll find out together what the result. Well, guys, Got the results right here. Let's go home and see what we got.
All right. Let's take a look.
Hey, Nature Boy, did you hear that? Let's rewind that.
Let's take a look.
All right.
I've got the results right here. I can't lie, I'm a little bit nervous. So we'll see how this goes. Let's go ahead and open it up. I don't know what I'm going to tell Mrs. Peete when she finds out about this. I hope this doesn't mean I have to pay child support, too.
It does mean that.
All right. Here we go. Dear Mr. Peete, enclosed are the results of the paternity test that you requested between Clemson and the Ohio State University. To be sure that the results are as accurate as possible, we have tested these samples against each other 31 times. The results were an unequivocal 31-0 result. Meaning that there is a 99.999 chance that Clemson is indeed Ohio State's daddy. The reason our company's paternity tests are held to the gold standard and used by courts across the land is because we use our due diligence to do a backstory. So after testing samples from the 1978 Orange Bowl.
It's the Gator Bowl, by the way, not the Orange Bowl.
2014 Orange Bowl. And last but not least, the 2016 Fiesta Bowl semifinal round of the college football playoff. The results for Clemson were 3-0. So we are happy to report to you that unequivocally, Clemson is indeed Ohio State's daddy. A little emotional. Look, now that I think about it, I do not mind paying child support for my little Buckeyes. as long as I'm allowed to see them every other weekend and during the summers. Have a great day, Pigskin Peete.
What the fuck? It's been a long time since I've seen that.
I don't know this, but if you have a YouTube app on your phone, you could be using it to make up to $10,000 a month thanks to a new loophole that exists in the YouTube algorithm.
Shut up.
This loophole.
Look at all this stuff that comes up related. Yeah, alimony and child support videos, ads for lawyers. how I beat child support. Where is... What was the name of the video that I did well, here's what I'll do. Pigskin Peete Daddy. Let's do that. I think that might bring it up. Yes. So after the results that I got back from the paternity test were 99.9999% accurate, that indeed Clemson is Ohio State's daddy. I did fear that I would have to pay child support, which I had no problem paying child support as long as I got to see my little Buckeyes on the weekends or every other weekend and during the summertime, right? It's only fair. But here's the follow-up to that. Now, this one here is even more ridiculous.
And it's really not even close. For those of you guys that were here last year at this time when I sent off for a paternity test to be done to prove once and for all that Clemson is Ohio State's daddy, we got the results back right here on the Pigskin Peete YouTube channel, and I read them live on air. There was a 99.99% chance that Clemson wasn't indeed Ohio State's daddy. But just like I thought would happen, now that it is confirmed daddy status, I have some child support problems to take care of. So let's call the Ohio...
One of the comments I remember very clearly on this video, it might have even been one of you, fat shaming Peete. Yeah. Somebody said I looked fat. This was fat Peete. Everybody get a good gander. Yeah, get a good laugh. Fat Peete.
Ohio State, or the state of Ohio, child support office. Let's do it.
State of Ohio Child Support, how may I help you?
Oh, yes, hello. I was calling in relation to a youngin' that I may or may not have up there in the state of Ohio.
May I have your name, sir?
Yeah, my name is Peete Sweeney. That's Peete with three E's, P-double-E-T-E. Sweeney is S-W-I-N-N-E-Y.
Are you a current resident of the state of Ohio?
Oh, no, sir. I'm originally from Alabama. I've lived the past 20 years or so in this small town in the upstate of South Carolina. It's called Clemson. You might have heard of it.
I see. Well, what can I do for you today?
Well, I'm in a bit of a predicament involving back child support from a woman that lives up there in Franklin County in Columbus, Ohio, who contacted me on Facebook about this time last year and claimed that I had a youngin' with her. I guess the best thing for me to do is just go ahead and explain from the beginning. It'll all make a lot more sense. So it was about 6 years ago, a couple of buddies and myself, we went on vacation for the weekend to Myrtle Beach. Are you familiar with Myrtle Beach, South Carolina?
Yes, sir. I'm very familiar with Myrtle Beach.
Yeah, well, that's good. A couple of my old high school buddies and I decided to go down there for the weekend. We spent the day fishing out on the water, drinking a couple of cold ones, you know what I mean? And then that one night, we decided we're going to shower up and put on our best, you know, and go out to Senior Frogs. It's a fine establishment down there in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Anyway, you know, the drinks were flowing, the margaritas were flowing there at Senior Frogs, and apparently I had one too many. I met this beautiful young lady at the bar. One thing led to another. We ended up in the bathroom at Senior Frogs. And, well, I'm not going to tell you exactly what happened after that. I think you could probably use your imagination, though. But anyway, to make a long story short, about a year ago, I get a message on Facebook. And this woman that claims that she was the woman from Senior Frogs that night, and I barely had any recollection of it until she told me in painstaking detail exactly what did go happen in that bathroom. Anyway, she told me I had a youngin' that I didn't know about. He was now 5 years old. Now, I just flat out told her I didn't believe her because I didn't even believe that I was the first one to have my way with her that night, if you know what I mean. I could kind of tell, but there's really no way I could prove it. So I told her to send me one of them paternity tests, one of them home kits, you know, where you swab your cheek and you send it off to one of them scientific labs. Well, I did that this time last year, and sure enough, I got a letter in the mail about 30 days after I sent that test off, and it said, indeed, there was a 99.999% chance that I was this youngin's daddy.
Well, that's a great story, sir. However, I'm still not clear on exactly what you want from us.
Well, this is the child support office in Ohio, and she's claiming to me that I owe her $18,000 in back child support when I didn't even know about this young until about a year ago. Not to mention, I don't even have $18,000 to give her, okay? I mean, I would have to sell my double wide and a couple of my heifers, and I can't afford to do that. Things are really, really tight financially for me right now.
Again, sir, I'm not sure what you want from me.
Well, I'm not really sure either. I mean, this is the child support office. I have child support problems, so I figured I'd call you. I mean, I can't call the police. Every time I call the police, I end up in handcuffs or something. I'm already on probation now. I can't afford to do that again. So I'm just in a predicament. Can you at least look up the youngin's name and the woman's name in question and tell me if she's lying to me? Do I really owe $18,000 in back child support?
Okay, what's the mother of the child's name and the child in question's name?
The mother's name is Karen Day, And the youngin' in question, he's a little urban. We named him Urban Day. She named him after Keith Urban, the country singer. You know who that is, don't you? Yeah, he's a good-looking feller. I mean, I never met him before, but a couple of weeks ago, she did put me on one of them iPhones, and we did FaceTime, and that's the first time I met the little fella. He's good-looking, too. He does kind of look like me. His eyes are crossed, which she says that'll fix itself eventually. I don't know if that's true or not. But, you know, the way he looked at me with those crossed eyes, I felt an instant connection with him.
Sir, stop wasting my time. Do not call back here again. You hear me?
Yeah, I don't know. That's clearly the most ridiculous video I've ever made in my life. I mean, it's really not even close. And I've made some ridiculous videos, but trust me. Trust me. I don't even know if there is a Senor Frogs in Myrtle Beach. Probably is. There's a Senor Frogs in every party town, you know. Maybe if we do have the Slob Olympics at Panama City Beach, like Traveling Fools recommended, maybe I guarantee you there's a Senor Frogs there. We'll have to go to it. What's up, Scott? All right, let's get to the news, shall we? And then I'll open up the StreamYard.
Breaking news from the Pigskin Peete YouTube channel.
You know, one is good, you know, two are better, you know.
You know.
And okay. then if you get three, well, that's just good business.
Video shows the moment a teacher was sucked out of a classroom during a rare California tornado. What? What's going on in California? I mean, they got flooding rains going on after years of drought. Now they got tornadoes, bro. I don't know what's going on. It's the end of times, I think. A teacher was sucked out of her classroom by the powerful winds of a tornado near downtown Los Angeles on March 22nd. A frightening moment was captured in a cell phone video and involved a teacher at Vail High School in Montebello, California. They better not tickle my ass with a feather and tell me there's a video and then I'd have a video on here. I hate when they do that. There's a that's not a video. It's a picture. And I don't see a tornado in there. The teacher reportedly cracked open the door after her students told her that someone had run outside, at which point the wind blew the door open and pulled her off her feet, sucking her outside. All of a sudden, we opened the door a little bit. Then we just see a gust of wind starting to build up. Then it got faster and faster, said a high school senior. The teacher sustained minor injuries from the incident. This was the strongest twister to hit the Los Angeles metro area since 1983, according to the National Weather Service. With peak winds of 110 miles per hour, the tornado wreaked havoc, damaging 17 buildings in an industrial warehouse and commercial business district, and apparently school. One building suffered an almost total roof collapse, and the HVAC unit was ejected from the top of the structure. The tornado, which touched down on the ground for about 2 to 3 minutes. Tornadoes are rare in California, but this was the second twister to hit the Golden State within 24 hours. The NWSA, which is the National Weather Service, confirmed that a weak, narrow tornado touched down at a mobile home park about 100 miles away near Santa Barbara. That's where my sister lives, Santa Barbara. On March 21st, damaging around 25 mobile homes. These tornadoes are the latest in a series of severe weather events to hit California in recent weeks, including a catastrophic flooding and rare blizzards. There you go. I always think it's funny when people from California are like, man, I would never want to live on the East Coast like you guys. I couldn't handle all those hurricanes. I'm like, hurricanes? Jesus. California has more natural disasters than any state in the union. I mean, mudslides, floods, fires, earthquakes, apparently tornadoes now. Yeah, no thank you, bro. No thank you, bro. Notre Dame football rising junior safety no longer with the program. Yeah, I believe, I'm not going to click on that, but there was a guy, a Notre Dame player who retired from football for medical reasons. I think that's who that is. How the hell, this is not me saying this. This is the title of the article. How the hell did this truck end up on its roof in this Chick-fil-A drive-thru? You know what? This truck ended up on its roof in a Chick-fil-A drive-thru, and I bet you he still got his food on time. Yeah. I guarantee it. I bet they delivered that thing. He didn't even get out of the car. And they gave him extra sauce, too. If I told you there was a wreck in a drive-thru at a Chick-fil-A, you probably wouldn't have much of a reaction. I might get a disinterested cool out of you. I'm trying to stay calm now. Do we have any writers? I know we have an actual writer, a professional writer that listens to the show. He doesn't usually listen to it live, but he listens to it later, and he comments on almost every live show, and I appreciate that. You guys may know him affectionately as a man named Dade Star Mysteries. That's his YouTube call name. He's a writer. I would like to know his opinion on this. Now, I realize there's a difference between writing novels and books, fiction and nonfiction, and writing articles for newspapers or websites or whatever. Anytime I read a news article and the writer goes out of his way to try to show you how funny he is, instead of just reporting on what they're reporting on, I lose immediate interest. If they use the word I, like this man did, or I don't even know if it's a man or a woman. Let's see here. Colin Woodard. So it's a man. Or at least he identifies as one. Anytime you use the word I lose interest. And when you start saying, I might get disinterested, and then you quote yourself, this man, he's quoting himself in a news article. Am I crazy? Does anybody else get perturbed by this? Am I the only one that gets perturbed by this? He says, I might get disinterested, quoting himself, cool. At best, you might say, I guess they should have gone to Popeyes. He's trying to be funny, but he's not. All right, I'll move on. After all, what's the worst that could happen when cars are inching forward at an incredibly low speeds? But what if I told you this particular crash ended up with a pickup sitting on its roof? Suddenly, things got a lot more interesting. Well, you know what? The one thing is not interesting so far is this fucking article. I'll tell you that right now. Oh, look where this happened. It happened in South Carolina. It happened in Florence, South Carolina yesterday. Apparently, the driver of a Dodge Caliber hit a stop sign, ended up going airborne, and hit the Ford F-150 in a way that caused it to flip over onto its roof. Thankfully, no one was killed in the crash, but the driver was taken to the hospital with minor injuries. And somehow, the driver of the upside-down pickup truck escaped with no injuries. The driver of the Caliber was also charged with disregarding traffic control device. So here's a picture of it. I guarantee you, knowing Chick-fil-A, they didn't stop business for this. The drive-thru continued to roll, and nobody spent more than 8 minutes and 15 seconds in there. That's how I know. But after reading the report and seeing the pictures, I still left with so many questions. And since it doesn't appear that anyone caught the crash on video, we're unlikely to ever get answers. Mainly, how the hell did a pickup truck end up on its roof? Getting knocked on its side would make sense. I just got hit by a car that was flying through the air. I hate this person. Shame. Shame. I don't hate that person. I hate that article. Alien mothership lurking in our solar... Hold on now, bro. You know what I got to do here. Alien mothership lurking in our solar system could be watching us with tiny probes, Pentagon official suggests. What? This is not the fake news segment with Scott Kerr. This is the real news segment. But this here sounds to me like fake news. God, I wish this was real. Am I the only one that wishes aliens were really real and would show up? You know? Could an alien mothership be hovering around the solar system, sending out tiny probes to explore planets? According to a Harvard scientist and a Pentagon official, it's possible. Of course it's possible. Anything's possible. I mean, they bred a tiger and a lion. It's called a liger. If they can do that, there's definitely a possibility of aliens. In a draft paper, the paper said that it's feasible an extraterrestrial spaceship could be in our galactic neighborhood exploring the region by the means of dandelion seeds, small spacecraft that can gather and send back information similar to the way humans send out spacecraft to explore other planets. Now, this is how you write an article. Colin, or whatever the F your name is from the last article, take notes. Relax and take notes. This is how you write, bro. Easy to read. Not trying to make people laugh at his dumbass jokes. All right, where was I? Avi Loeb, an astronomer at Harvard University, and Sean M. Kirkpatrick, director of Pentagon's All Domain Anomaly Resolution Office. What the hell is that? This is where your tax dollars are going, people. I got something called an All Domain Anomaly Resolution Office. Yeah. You know that $100 they took out of your paycheck? Or whatever, but shit, depends on how much you make. You know that $500 they took out of your paycheck last month? Yeah, it went to fund the All Domain Anomaly Resolution Office. they established in 2022, of course, by the Department of Defense to detect and study objects of interest, released the draft Physical Constraints on Unidentified Aerial Phenomena, or UAPs, for all of you cosmonauts out there, on March 7th. It's not an official Pentagon document, of course it's not, but it was carried out in partnership with the DOD. It has not been peer-reviewed. And by peer-reviewed means, well, you know what it means, but I'll tell you what peer-reviewed means. It means absolutely nothing in reality. Loeb is known for his research into Oumuamua, an interstellar visitor from beyond the solar system, which is this elongated sort of asteroid-looking deal here that, you know, people think it's like a spaceship, basically. Astronomers first detected the cigar-shaped object in 2017 and originally thought it was a comet. However, its elongated shape and lack of a coma, which is the tail that comes off the back of a comet, and the fact that it was accelerating away from the sun instead of towards it raised questions about the comet theory. Loeb suggests instead that Oumuamua is an alien spaceship. The Epstein mothership. 6 months before Oumuamua's close approach to Earth, a small interstellar meteor measuring around 3 feet wide smashed into Earth. This meteor, IM2, was not related to Oumuamua. But it got Loeb thinking. That coincidence inspired him to consider the possibility that an artificial interstellar object could potentially be a parent craft or mothership that releases many small probes during its close passage to Earth. An operational construct not too dissimilar from NASA missions. Quote, these dandelion seeds could be separated from a parent craft by the tidal gravitational force of the sun or by a maneuvering capability. This is a long article, but I am fascinated. In the draft paper, Loeb and Kirkpatrick looked at the unidentified anomalous phenomenon, UAP, confined by its own physics. The authors suggest that the dandelion seed probes could reach Earth for exploration without being detected by astronomers, as they would likely be too small to reflect enough sunlight for survey telescopes to detect. Aliens would likely want to explore rocky planets with an atmosphere in a solar system. From a distance, Venus, Earth, and Mars would all look appealing, with Earth being the greatest of interest once aliens found signatures of liquid water. The alien civilization that created the probes would not need to be on the mothership. It would be unlikely that it could even communicate with the probes. Now, hold on now. You lost me there, bro. Why would it be unlikely that the probes could communicate with the mothership? I don't understand that. I mean, if you can travel across the galaxy, interstellar space travel in that, you telling me they don't have a CB radio on that motherfucker? I call him bullshit on that. That's right. I mean,
that is bullshit!
You just lost all credibility with me, Harvard man. The alien civilization may not even exist anymore. Most stars in the solar system formed billions of years ago before the sun. A habitable planet with intelligent life could have been sending out probes long before Earth was even formed, searching. Resembles checking our mailbox for any packages that may have accumulated over time there, even if the senders are not even alive anymore. Well, that there. This brings me to my theory about, you know, these aliens that are visiting us not even being alive anymore, which doesn't make any sense at all. But what if they were never alive to begin with? Huh? Think about that. Right? I think if there is alien ships here from another planet or another dimension or whatever, it's most likely these aren't biological beings. Artificial intelligence. That's right. You heard me. Robots.
Yeah. Uh-huh. That's right.
All right. Well, the music ended, so I guess that means the article ended too. So there you go. Boater stops to use the restroom in a Florida yard. This is Florida man stuff here. And thousands have seen the video. Well, there's how many people are in here? 36. There's about 1,036 people that watch this video because we're about to watch it. That's if they posted it. I wonder if this guy just, you know, took a leak or if he took a dump in this people's yard. That'd be weird. You know, peeing, not so weird. But if you crap in somebody's bushes, that is weird. And of course, in typical Yahoo fashion, they put video in the title of the article and then don't show the effing video. A boater enjoying a day on the Florida's Lake Winterset tried supposedly to use the restroom in someone's lawn. That's an oxymoron. There is no such thing as a restroom in somebody's lawn. There's such thing as a lawn. But a restroom would assume that there's a room which there clearly isn't. And she missed seeing the security cameras. Okay, so it's a woman. So we don't know. She might have been pooping. She might have been peeing. We have no idea because women crouch either way or squat or whatever you want to call it, you know. That oversight has resulted in nearly 80,000 people, well, officially 80,035 people now, watching the awkward moment on Facebook and YouTube. Thousands more have posted reactions and comment. Well, this is, what? How is this news? This is just stupid. Everyone's peed in somebody's bushes. This isn't news. Moving on. I might even do it before the day's over, pissing somebody's bushes. Who knows? I don't know. The day's still young. Men hurl drugs from the car before a police chase ends in a deadly crash, Georgia cops say. Yeah, I don't want to read that. Sorry. Just don't want to do it. A new ocean could form in Africa as the continent continues to split apart. Hey, good news, guys. If you're still around, if you happen to live, maybe they'll, I don't know, maybe they'll find some way to live forever, you know, immortality. But if you do happen to live another 10 million years, you might get to see an ocean form because Africa's splitting apart. That's good news. A new ocean could form in the distant future after a split continues from Africa. This is the only place on Earth where you can study how a continental rift becomes an oceanic rift. We can see that the oceanic crust is starting to form because it's distinctly different from the continental crust in its composition and density. The split formed in the desert of Ethiopia, creating a possibility that countries such as Kenya and Uganda could develop a coastline as new ocean forms in a crevice. Ethiopia, my dad went there when he was in the Navy. For like 6 months and brought back some pretty cool stuff, including slideshows. Well, one of the things that was most interesting to me was this village that he was living in had, well, first of all, everyone's poor, right? But there would be these wild hyenas, which I guess is also an oxymoron. I mean, there's no such thing as a domesticated hyena, but there would be these hyenas that would come into the town, and there would be these people out there who, for if you're a tourist or maybe even just a villager, for entertainment purposes, they would hand feed these hyenas. Now, a lot of times, the hyena would do more than just eat the food. They would bite their hand. They would bite their. So he said there was people walking around with missing fingers, missing hands. For feeding hyenas for money. So don't complain about your job. You could be having to feed hyenas for money. Okay. So here's a picture of this here. Where this is the, this is where the Africa is splitting apart, according to this article and the scientists involved. So this is how it starts. And then 10 million years from now, this will be an ocean. There you go. I just condensed that whole article for you in about two sentences. You're welcome. Now, I'm not going to click on this because it's trigger warning confirmed. But just the title of it is funny. Well, it's funny and sad. Author says that people of color need to say goodbye to white people.
Wow,
What is going on in this world? Oh, look at this. You guys know Afro Man, right? You know the guy, I mean, the one-hit wonder Afro Man? Because I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high. Rap artist Afro Man sued by officers who raided his home. What? Now, this is some... The officer sued Afro Man? I don't even know what happened. I'm on Afro Man's side, okay? That's all I know. Afro Man, whose real name is Joseph Foreman, poses in a portrait. Okay, that's just the... all right. Seven law enforcement officers have sued rap artist Afro Man, accusing him of improperly using footage from a police raid on his Ohio home. Oh, my God.
People are like, oh, dude, you fucking roasted or you roasted.
improperly using footage from a police raid on his Ohio home last year. Let me say that again. For anybody who's in the back who's not listening, clean the wax and the dirt out of your ears, okay? I'm gonna say it slowly, and I'm gonna say it clearly. Seven law enforcement officers have sued rap artist Afro Man, accusing him of improperly using footage from a police raid on his Ohio home last year in his music videos. How? I don't even know where to begin with this. I don't even need to read anymore. I'm going to, though, but I don't need to. Let me tell you something. This is very simple. If you are in somebody's home, it doesn't matter whether you're there on official business or for pleasure or anything, any reason. If you are in somebody's home on personal private property, they can film you all the hell they want. Doesn't matter if you're a police officer or not. You're in their home. And the reason these people are probably suing him, I'm going to continue to read the article. I'm trying to stay calm here. But the reason they're probably suing him is because they probably acted like a bunch of effing buffoons while they were raiding his home. And they're mad about it. And they don't want to be exposed in public about it. Four deputies, two sergeants, and a detective with the Adams County Sheriff's Office brought the suit earlier this month, claiming invasion of privacy. Jesus fucking. You're in this man's house talking about invasion of privacy. What is going on? Other law enforcement officers were involved in the raid were not named as plaintiffs. The plaintiffs say the rapper, whose real name is Joseph Foreman, took footage of their faces obtained during the August. They got footage of my face on a raid. Cry about it. I want to see this video now. I want everyone else to go watch this music video too. You're going to laugh at these fucking morons. They say that this caused them emotional distress, embarrassment, ridicule, and loss of reputation and humiliation. Good. Jesus Christ. And they stole money from him. Moving on. Yeah. Yeah, I can't even get over that last article. That just twisted my brain into a pretzel. Can't even read anymore. Fiery Florida plane crash leaves a couple and dog severely injured. Quite terrifying. Two people and a dog are injured after a small plane crash shortly after taking off in northeastern Florida. It's always in Florida, isn't it? Look at this. Holy shit, look at that. Good Lord, man. If that's the picture, they are lucky that they're just injured and not dead. St. John's County Fire and Rescue said multiple agencies responded to a 911 call reporting a plane that had crashed into the woods across from Northeast Regional Airport runway in St. Augustine. The crews arrived and the plane was on fire approximately 100 yards from the wind line, or into the wind line, rather. Look at that thing. Burned up, bro. Florida Action News Jacksonville reported that the husband was piloting the plane when the control was lost during takeoff, so it didn't even really crash. It did crash, but it never even really took off, resulting into it crashing into a tree line. The man was taken to University of Florida Gainesville to be treated for burns, while the woman was taken to the Memorial Hospital in Jacksonville. The dog was also taken to a local vet with injuries. So it sounds like they give the man, look at that. I saw a lady being helped out of the woods, Delaney Romity said. This was a witness. It was quite terrifying, in all honesty. Yeah, I bet it was. Slim, you haven't been around me with the police, sir. You know, you might not be saying that. All right, let's get to the StreamYard, shall we? What's up? Welcome to the Midday Show. Do 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 do. I wonder what I can do to wake him up. This?
Pathetic! You are pathetic!
Hey, Battle Angel, welcome to the family. And thank you, Nature Boy, for gifting that that membership. I appreciate you. I wonder how long I should wait before I hang up on him. He's been in the back room since the show started, so for about an hour, well, over an hour. Maybe some jackpot will wake him up. That's a good idea. Let's do that.
Can you pose yourself as some kind of a fucking running threat?
DeAndre!
You fucking fuck!
DeAndre! DeAndre Johnson! Who the fuck is he? You fucking freshman!
Andre Johnson. Who the fuck is he? He's fucking freshman.
You say, like, well, they've been hanging tough. Well, they've been playing as good as they can.
Andre Johnson. Who the fuck is he? He's fucking.
Oh, how about that? You say, like, well, they've been hanging tough. Well, they've been playing as good as they can.
Oh, how about that? Jackpot Leslie makes one.
Why are you telling me?
Oh, how about that?
You don't have this.
Jackpot Leslie makes one.
You don't have this, and you don't have that. God, I love Jackpot. Oh, man. What's up? Well, welcome to the Midday Show.
Is he asleep? Just walk away and do something.
I think he's probably walking. He's a truck driver, too. He's probably outside of his rig right now doing something. That's what I would imagine. I'm just going to leave him up here, and eventually he'll figure it out. I don't know.
Or he won't.
Whatever. It's no skin off my back.
Oh.
I'm a sick individual, Slim. You know, I could sit, I'm not even kidding you. I could probably sit here, not even being on the air or recording anything, and just put my headphones on and do what I just did with those jackpot clips for an hour to entertain myself. I'm such a child. I'm not even kidding.
I'm about to say, I really don't think you're kidding.
I'm not kidding. That's the sad part.
What's equally not as funny is I'd probably sit there and listen to it. I mean, at least you're pressing the buttons and mixing it up a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, that's actually half the fun, you know? It's like DJ, right? It's like playing DJ Peete over here. You know what I mean?
And then mix in what's-her-name with it, because she sounds almost just like him. Did we ever figure out her name? Or is she just forever labeled big-breasted flat earth?
Oh, this one?
People are like, oh, dude, you fucking roasted her, you roasted her.
You could pop her right in the middle of it, and you would know the difference.
People are like, oh, dude, you fucking roasted her, you roasted her.
I've heard that a million times, and I still don't know what she says. She says, people are like, dude, your brother something.
People are like, dude, you fucking roasted her, you roasted her.
Mix her in with that Irish chick. They sound just like
her. You said, what's her name? Well, I don't know. I think her name on, I don't know if it's a real name or not, but I think her name on the what's it called? TikTok. I think her name on TikTok is Jenny Rose. So I guess her name is Jenny. Jenny.
Yeah, sounds like a stage name.
Yeah, probably. Who knows? Oh.
She was given that name doing some auditions out in California.
See if I can find her here. See what she's up to. That's the one thing I hate about TikTok.
She gave up the flat earth stuff. And
well, she went back to bikini videos. Yeah, I mean, she made a smart business move. That's what that was.
Well, and I mean, apparently she's not an intelligent enough individual to watch the Midday Show. But I've tried giving her advice several times is to do the flat earth stuff while wearing a bikini, and it might help her out.
Well, she did post one video, I remember very clearly, of herself in a bikini, but it was a flat earth bikini. It said flat earth on it, and it had, like, you know, the diagram that the flat earthers use as their model.
Yeah.
Like the disc shaped earth with the ice wall around it. That was on the bikini, which is actually pretty smart. I got to admit.
Well, and it's kind of ironic considering what it's like.
Yeah. Now I'm looking at TikTok right now, and somebody told me last time we were looking at her videos that no, Pete, she didn't stop doing flat earth videos. She just started a whole different TikTok. Like, she has two accounts. You know how some people have two YouTube channels? So she has one, which from what I'm looking at here, the one with the like 80,000 or 70,700 followers, that's the bikini account, clearly.
Right.
And then the flat earth one appears has much, much less.
Like seven.
Yeah. Well, if I get involved, maybe eight. But let's see what she's up to. Yeah, she's definitely abandoned the flat earth deal.
That's a shame.
Ooh, hold on now. Let me put this up for all the people to see. This is very important. This is scientific purposes only. Mrs. Peete, don't get mad. All right. This is just for research purposes. What is this? Looks like she was on a podcast. Let's see what this is.
I think you have the best revenge story.
At the end of the day, the dude has a tattoo of your face. You win.
This dude.
Is it a portrait?
It's my face. It's me going like this. And I have the original photo. And then
Wait. Cut it back.
I've never heard nipples.
You said nipples.
Someone said
initials.
Jesus Christ.
I heard nipples too.
I got it.
Your nipples are gorgeous. I just want to get them tatted.
Oh, that's my girl's nipples, dude.
What did I just watch? Huh?
I said I can't see or hear it. So what did she do now?
The only thing I don't even know. She posted a clip of, she's on some podcast with three simps. This might be the worst. I don't know. What am I doing wrong, Slim? Because the fact that these three jabronis here has even one person listening to them blows my mind. I mean, Jesus Christ. All right, now here we go. This is what I'm talking about. I'm a scientist.
You look lonely. I can't fix that.
I mean, what? I could see how she'd be useful for scientific research, but
sipping ain't easy. In the city, but it's fun. What? Whoa! Holy crap! Alright, I gotta turn this off. I gotta turn this off. Let's get back to regularly scheduled programming.
I may have to go back and watch this for research.
Oh, man.
See, now you have my curiosity piqued. I can't see it. What am I missing?
Well, nothing anymore. I turned it off. I had to. But it's official. You know, when I was playing the intro music for the show today, and I told you I heard possibly, well, not possibly, I did hear the worst song I've ever heard in my life, which is now stuck in my head, by the way. It's an anomaly. Twice in one day, I heard the worst song ever, and I saw a clip from the worst podcast on the planet, all in the same day. It's like it's a miracle, actually, that happened.
Well, the fact that the Logan brothers have made millions of dollars and millions of people watch them should tell you all you need to know about the internet. People are fucking stupid.
Well, that might be the truest thing you've ever said, Slim.
I say a lot of true things. Mine is that rare genius that will not be fully appreciated until after I'm long gone.
I feel like that's the same with me. I don't think I'll be fully appreciated until I'm buried. And then people would be like, you remember that guy, Pigskin Pete? Yeah, he's, his show was pretty good. I wonder why only 30 people watched it every day. I don't know.
But you and me both will become known as the great philosophers of our time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, up there with the likes of Nostradamus and Socrates.
I wish I could get her to come on my podcast. I don't even know
That'd
if that's
what amazing.
I guess this is technically a podcast, right? Even though it's not on a podcast platform. Maybe you know what I should start doing? I should start uploading these shows to podcast platform.
Yeah, put it on like Spotify, and iTunes, and Apple Play. And all
right.
That.
And maybe if I did that, I could get Jenny Rose on the show. I would love to have her on. She would never come on my show. But I would love even just 5 minutes of interviewing her would be awesome. 5 minutes. I can't get a flat earther to come on the show. I even gave up trying.
And that really is a shame.
It is a shame.
If you believe in it that much,
right?
Come on and defend your ideas.
Yeah. They all say the same thing to me whenever I contact them. They're like, well, you come on. Well, this is the problem. This is one of the reasons I don't. Well, there's a lot of reasons I don't like TikTok or really do much on there anymore is because of the way that they do their live shows. Like this YouTube channel, anybody can come on my show. Right? You're on here right now.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do that on TikTok. If you go live on, first of all, you have to have 1,000 followers to even be able to go live. That's number one. And then if you want to have somebody join your live show, then they have to have 1,000 followers, which is complete. I don't even know. What's the point of that? So when I go on these Flat Earth live shows, You remember the guy? Yeah. Where is he? This guy.
I still love you, but I don't like it, bro. This is, do you know what independence looks like, bro? You're staring at it.
That guy, I went on his live show and got him all hot and bothered and perturbed from me typing in the comments section. And I invited him. I said, please come on my YouTube show. And of course, he's like, no, sorry, bro. You need to get 1,000 followers and you can come on my show. Sorry you don't have 1,000 followers. I'm like, Jesus fucking Christ, man.
Well, I mean, I would ask why the CCP has set up these rules for TikTok, but Belushi's back in a concentration camp, so we can't ask him.
Yeah, where is he?
Back in a concentration camp. I just told you.
Yeah.
You know, maybe they found out he was a Muslim.
I meant to actually mention him at the beginning of the show. If I go more than like 10 days without hearing from Volusia or seeing him in a comment section somewhere, I do actually start to worry about him because of where he is.
Well, for good reason, sir.
Yeah.
Despite how safe he thinks it is.
Yeah, well, yeah. So Volusia, if you happen to hear this later, by a small chance, if you happen to be watching this show at a later time, can you at least leave me a comment in the comment section with a thumbs up or, you know, how, just anything so that I know you're alive. Thank you.
Put SOS in sign language so we know.
Yeah, can you send
built.
Can you send up a smoke signal?
we'll send a couple F-16s right over.
Yeah, I mean, if they find out this man's watching YouTube, they might throw him in jail.
Shit, they might.
Yeah. Imagine that. You get a knock on your door. You're in China. Yeah, who is it? Open the door. That's my Chinese accent, by the way. Open the door. Why? What? Who is it? We know you are under arrest, Volusia. You've been watching Pigskin Pete YouTube channel.
Shit. Here he goes down the fire escape.
You are sentenced to death by fire. Is that a good Chinese accent?
It's not bad, but you know what? You may not actually be too far off. Because, God, I saw a video of it. It was like a 6 or 8 minute clip from one of Joe Rogan's podcasts. He was talking to this lady that got out of North Korea, which, you know, North Korea has very similar rules to China. Mm-hmm. And Like, she was talking about how they would send inspectors to your house at random.
Uh-huh.
And you must have pictures up of the Kim family. And, like, they'll give them the white glove treatment. If there's dust on them, you can be sentenced to death.
Oh, you're talking about North Korea? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm sure it's no different with the CCP in China.
You know what the greatest movie ever made was? I forget the name of it now. Well, yeah, I did. Somebody in the chat might know. It's the movie with I can't remember the actor's name. shit. What's the guy's name? The guy who plays in the comedian guy who plays in all the weed movies. Jesus, the Canadian guy.
There's a lot of Canadians.
I destroyed this bit. I know somebody knows who I'm talking about.
The Canadian who plays in all the weed movies. I mean...
Yeah, Sea Dog loves that movie. The movie that nobody knows what it is.
Fucking How High? I don't know.
No. Jesus Christ. The main guy in Pineapple Express. That's what I'm talking about. Seth, thank you. Rogen. So the Seth Rogen movie where he goes to North Korea. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh yeah, with him and James Franco.
Yes, there you go. That's the greatest movie ever made. It only took me 10 minutes to tell you about it. But when they smoke a bunch of weed with Kim Jong Un. And like he's got like a big arcade, and he's like, "You want to go in the tank?" They go in the fucking tank, and
the dictator. Isn't that the name of the movie?
Oh, The Interview is what it's called. That shit's hilarious, man.
No, the dictator is Adam Sandler. My bad.
Yeah. And no, I'm not talking about. Man, I'm having a hard time with names today. I might need to end the show. The basketball player that went over there. The fuck is his name? Jesus Christ.
Oh, I don't remember which one. It was one of the Ball brothers.
No. What's his name?
Oh, no, you're talking about North Korea. You're talking about Dennis Rodman.
Yeah, Dennis Rodman. Thank you. Jesus Christ. You would think
Dennis Rodman to be friends with that motherfucker.
You would think I'm high right now. I'm not.
Sober as a judge, people.
Which was funnier? The Seth Rogen movie, The Interview, where he goes over to interview Kim Jong-un, or the actual interview that happened with Dennis Rodman? Not even... You remember when the whole team went... The whole damn... they paid a bunch of former NBA players to go over there and play against the North Korean basketball team? Let's see if I can find a video of that.
Well, I'm automatically going to pick Dennis Rodman because Seth Rogen, to me, wore thin about 10 years ago. After about the dozenth movie where he plays the stoner loser.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm with you on that. Yeah. Let's see here. What do I type in here? North Korea. Oh, I might get a knock on my door for even typing this in YouTube. North Korea, Dennis Rodman.
Although I'm not sure if the movie critics will agree with your takes on greatest movie ever. I mean, some people say Gone with the Wind. Some people say...
Ah, nonsense.
Some people say The Shawshank Redemption.
Well, they haven't seen The Interview then. I mean, I don't know what to tell you.
Oh, that's awesome.
The best one was whenever he came back from North Korea, Dennis Rodman. And of course, he's catching hell because people are like, why are you going over there, being all buddy pals with fucking a dictator who's like one of the most brutal people on the planet? Like the human rights violations going on in North Korea. And Dennis Rodman, of course, in the interview, he's completely hammered. It's like 12 o'clock in the afternoon. He's completely hammered. He can't even put a sentence together. He starts crying and shit. Like, you guys don't know Kim, you don't know the real Kim Jong-un. he's a really nice guy. And they're like, yeah, he's really nice to you. Meanwhile, he's enslaving half the population and starving them to death.
I mean, I'm in no way sticking up for, you know, the ruling family of North Korea, but, I mean, people don't talk about all the brutal dictators that the U.S. government's buddy-buddy with, so why are you worried about who Dennis Rodman's buddy-buddy with?
You remember that show with Dr. Drew? Celebrity Rehab, I believe what it was called.
Oh, God, yeah.
Now,
I remember seeing Flavor Flav on there.
Yeah, Flavor Flav. Well, Dennis Rodman went on there one time. And so he was trying to convince Dennis Rodman that he was causing brain damage from the amount of alcohol that he had drank throughout his life. And Dennis Rodman was like, oh, yeah, that's bullshit, you know. So they hooked this motherfucker up to like an EKG. I don't even know. They give him like an MRI. And they pull out on the damn show. He pulls out like the MRI image of brain activity on Dennis Rodman, and he's like got a pointer and shit, like a laser pointer. He's like, here's an image of your brain, Dennis. And Dennis is like, okay. And he's like, yeah, see this part right here? There's supposed to be activity there, but there's no more brain activity there because of alcohol damage. And he's like, do you understand? If you don't quit drinking, then you know you're going to continue to cause brain damage. He's like, yeah, I don't believe that.
Like, meanwhile, this is the same guy that went on a 48-hour bender during the NBA Finals in Vegas.
Oh,
he just needed to get away.
I really want to play this CNN interview with Dennis Rodman after he got back from North Korea, but I know CNN will take my shit down. I know it.
See, I one of us, probably you, because this is your channel.
Mm-hmm.
Need to figure out how all these other channels get away with playing CNN clips and it's just fine, or playing NFL clips.
I don't know.
There's like a fair use clause in law where, like, if you're comment, but I think you have to like put yourself on the screen with it. That may be
that I see. That's a good point. I don't know because you're right. I see it happen all the time.
Hey, yeah, I've seen those fair use notices popped up.
Yeah. So YouTube changed its policy, but never really told anybody about it. Like whenever I first came on YouTube years ago, you could play anything as long as it was on YouTube and it wouldn't be copyrighted or whatever they call it. But I learned something it was one of the call-in shows one night whenever we were watching another guy's YouTube channel, the Crockers. Remember that guy? It was Armadillo videos. I was searching Armadillo videos. I found him where he posted a video like years ago where he crawled up underneath like a shipping container that was on his property and like caught an armadillo by hand. And so he has like 300 something thousand, or he had like 300,000 something subscribers at the time. And he left a comment on my video, that call-in show. He left a comment on it. And was like, oh my God, your show is hilarious. And so I commented back. I was like, thanks. And he told me that since he's a verified channel, which this little check mark here, let me show you guys.
Bad Dog's got one.
Yeah, I think you have to have at least 100,000 subscribers to get verified or something. I don't know what the number is. Something like that.
So, yeah.
So you see this little, so you can see right here on the screen, you can't see it, Slim, but anytime there's a little verified check mark by the YouTube channel name right here, like Vice News, ABC News, all these, that means it's verified. That means anytime that somebody, if I were to play this video right now, if I were to click on this and play it, they would get a notification from YouTube that says, hey, Pigskin Pete channel played your video on his channel. And they will give you an option. Do you want to remove the video or have the video removed? So that's what this guy, the Crockers, told me. I didn't even know that was a thing. So he told me he did
that with some other channels.
Yeah. So he was like, he's like, people steal my material all the time. And yeah, most of the time I watch it and it's just, they're pirating my videos and monetizing it and trying to make money off of it. Right. Which I understand that if somebody were to take my videos and put ads on them and get 50,000 views when I only got 1,000, I'd be pissed about it too. Right. So I get that. But he said, I didn't have your video taken down because I watched it and you weren't, and it was funny, first of all, and you clearly weren't trying to steal it for profit. You were just having a good time. So it got left up. But
and I think the majority of people with like YouTube channels are cool with stuff like that. It's when you get into the ABCs and the big corporations that have YouTube channels. They're the ones that are going to be pricked about them and Lars Ulrich.
Right. Oh, look who woke up. Look who's there. I think. Didn't you just hear him?
I heard something.
Yeah. But anyway, I'm pretty sure if I played CNN or any of those news outlets that they would have my shit taken down immediately. And they probably wouldn't even review it. They would get the notification and some jerk off at a desk would just go ahead and hit, to take it down.
Well, CNN specifically, I follow channels that, they'll give their take on, some story CNN does or some story in the news. And yeah, it's not just CNN. But I know he's done CNN specifically, and those videos stay up. So, like I said, it's there's certain ways you have to do it. I just don't know them.
Yeah.
I'm finally awake.
About damn time, Nate. Shit, I was at work at 3 o'clock this morning.
Well, you work for some of the trucks.
Technically, the truck works for me.
See, unlike Dennis Rodman, Nate the Great's brain is fully functional.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, it is? Oh.
I guarantee you, your brain is much more functional than Dennis Rodman's.
Yeah.
Well, if it comes to other things, like girls, no, it's not. But yeah, it's functional.
Nate, I'll give you the best piece of advice I can give everybody. Leave the hose alone, bro.
Yeah. Yeah, what, Nate, he makes a good point. It might be a blessing in disguise, bro. You might need to just go ahead and embrace it. You know what I mean?
Embrace.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I went down the rabbit hole when everybody started making fun of Celine being MGTOW. And thank God I'm not in the dating market these days.
Yeah, I don't even know how to date.
Me either. I'm a single.
It's been so long, I wouldn't even know what to do, man. I mean, I would know what to do.
So you're used to going out into the world, trying to pick up chicks beforehand. That's not how shit works these days.
Right.
I know. But I want that to happen, but it's not going to happen. But
it'll happen. It'll happen whenever you least expect it and you're not trying to make it happen. That's the cruelty of life, Nate.
I wasn't trying to pick up a chick at a funeral. It just happened.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you known anybody that's died recently, Nate? As a matter of fact, you don't even need to know them. Just go to the obituaries in the newspaper. I mean, you could just show up. Do you have a suit?
I got a hazmat suit.
No, sir. No. Hold on. Back up. Why do you have a hazmat suit?
I don't know.
Wait, we know he has a suit because he just went to a wedding not long ago. We went through this.
Okay, so you have a nice suit and a tie and some nice, dress shoes and the whole deal, right?
Yeah.
All right. So here's what you do. You get the, when are the obituaries? Is that a daily thing? Nobody reads a newspaper anymore because everything's online. Is that just on Sunday's paper or is it a daily where they do? I think it's just a weekly thing. Obituary.
Yeah, I think it's just Sunday paper.
Yeah. So go to whatever supermarket, where they sell the newspaper still on Sunday. Grab yourself an Omaha, Nebraska Sunday Gazette or whatever the hell they call it there. I don't know. Go to the obituary section.
Mm-hmm.
Find a, well, I guess probably the best thing to do is find somebody who died around the age of between 60 and 70, because that means most likely they have daughters and granddaughters that are in their 30s and 20s. Okay. Now this is key because that's the age range. That's the age range you're going for, Nate. You're not going for anything under 20, right? I mean, that'd be okay because you're still young, but
maybe.
Well, 18 is still a cutoff age for Nate.
It definitely has to be over 18, but
is
I think Nate.
Okay.
How old?
It's over 18, Nate.
Yeah, it's got to be over 18. That's so but here's 19, but my suggestion is you go for somebody that's more, closer to 30, or hell, you could even go higher than that. You could even go to the 40 range, as long as Mama Nate approves. But here's what you do. So you find somebody who's just died recently, and they usually in the obituary will tell you where the funeral service is and what time. So if it's somewhere that's close to you, you can show up in your suit. Now, here's the thing. Don't say too much. As a matter of fact, don't say anything. Just sit in the back. All right. This, you will not make your move at the church or at the service. That's a bad place to make the move. People are very upset. They're crying. They're remembering their loved one. You know what I mean? The move is you wait to, you know, after the service, they go to the burial site, the graveyard. That's when you make the move. All right. You find the most distraught, hottest chick there, and you offer her your condolences. Now, she may ask you some questions like, oh, how did you know my father? You know, now, here's where you have to do your homework beforehand and find out what this guy did for a living. Where did he hang out? What was his favorite bar? What was his favorite baseball team? So right. This is where you can come up with your biggest lie of your life and say, well, I used to sit with your father at the Omaha base, you know, what's the minor league team in Omaha? The Omaha.
Omaha Storm Chasers.
I used to sit with your dad at the Omaha Storm Chasers game. He was a really, really nice guy. You know what I mean? And then so you make her.
I don't want to lie, though. That's the thing.
Yeah, sir. Every relationship, every married person's relationship is built on a lie, Nate.
At least one.
Not
three or four.
Yeah, fuck that. Yeah, forget about the Ten Commandments. Lying's okay, all right? Don't kill people or anything. And don't steal, but lying's fine. Lying's fine.
But also, I do have matches on Tinder, though.
Believe me, Nate, she's going to lie to you, too. So it's a two-way street.
Yeah.
But see, I mean, that kind of goes back to, you know, the problem I said when I was saying, thank God I'm not in the dating market. Because, you know, unfortunately for Nate and those younger than him, I mean, by the time a girl hits 30 these days,
ooh.
I mean, they've been run through by like 50 dudes. I mean, they're running around having hot girl summers all the fucking time. And they're wondering, like, why the fuck does anybody want to marry me? Because you've been run through by 50 dudes, bitch.
Hey, one thing I forgot to mention, Nate, about this. This is very important, too. Oh, look who dropped out. This man came on the show at 9. I started the show at 8:45. He came on at about 8:48 and never, he just now hung up and he never said one single word. I think he did cough once though. That was a great appearance. But Nate, here's what I forgot to tell you to do. This is very important too. So write this down. If you're going to do the funeral thing, like I suggest that you do, make sure that whatever woman you're trying to pick up at the funeral is not married already. You don't want to go down that road. Because then if you do that, you might be the next funeral. You know what I'm saying, bro?
I could tell because I'm tall, because I could tell by their hands when the hands, like, the ring.
Yeah, hands. But if they have a ring on or not.
Yeah. And plus, yeah.
Well, and there's all, look, Nate, there are tricks to this, because there's some women take the ring off.
That's
if
true.
If they got a patch of pasty white skin right there on that finger.
Well, if I mean, I know some women do that, but I would say, hell no, I'm not doing that.
Okay. And also, even more important than that, if they have excessive makeup on because they're trying to cover bruises on their face, then definitely don't talk to her.
Yeah, it's
all right. Or they're trying to hide a whole lot of ugly.
Yeah.
Catfishing
is a thing, sir.
When they have a makeup on, like you said, Pete, that's basically 100% transgender.
Okay. All right, Nate.
No, that's not. If you want to figure out if it's a tranny or not, the best method I could suggest if you want a visual aid is to go watch the original Crocodile Dundee movie. That's the best way to tell.
No, I know what transgender is.
Okay.
No, I'm saying
anyway.
That's how you can figure out.
Hey, Nate, Nate can't be choosy at this point. You might have to, you know, Lady Man might be acceptable at this point.
Don't
tell me
that.
Speaking of transgenders, don't show them your Slava Lipitz outfit.
Yeah.
I can just sell it to
Hey, look who's here. Hey, when it comes to desperate women at funerals, Nate,
you know, one is good, you know, two are better, you know,
you know,
and then if you get three, well, that's just good business. That's just good business.
Yeah, that's, well, according to Vic,
that may be the greatest thing ever said on YouTube.
Yeah, I may or may not have listened to that 100 times. Yeah. I can't confirm or deny.
What's my own stinger?
Right. Yeah. I think you can confirm, but yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's confirmed. Well, Nate doesn't have a stinger. You probably do need
one. No.
Nate needs a stinger.
You know what's
ironic? I said that.
Nate does need his own stinger, but every once in a while, Nate comes up with a gem of a, what I would consider to be a stinger material, but it's even too like far out there for me to play. And that's saying something, Nate.
Maybe if, when you're, if you're live or something like that, maybe like, let's say a Friday night Colin show.
Yeah.
Let's say, we're watching, for example, like you're watching a college football game, which is you usually don't on Colin shows, but, let's say I'm watching a Nebraska or Michigan game.
Well, I'm just going to go ahead and stop you there, Nate. So first of all, there's no planning that goes into finding a stinger material. It happens organically, but I know, I just know it when I hear it.
There you go.
Oh yeah.
You can't plan for it.
I don't know. Vic, has a stinger in me, but he, I raged so bad that he beat me in battleships.
See, it's so easy to make a stinger for people like Jackpot because he's like a walking stinger.
Yeah, I mean, speaking of stingers, I've never had a stinger, but I used to have it. What happened to my intro music?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I used to have intro music back in the day.
Yeah, he used to have intro music and a graphic, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I was always calling in. I very rarely got to see the graphic unless I was watching it back.
Yeah, it was basically a green screen with orange, like Miami orange colored letters that said Slim Shady. And it played the, hi, my name is, what? My name is, my name is Slim Shady. That was it. Oh, man, that was old. That was a long time ago.
That was.
That was on when I was doing my shows from a different computer. So that was probably 4 years ago.
And that's when you were still on the phone instead of StreamYard.
Yeah, back in my day.
Yeah. Yeah, that was at least 4 years ago. Because I've had my current computer for three years. And yeah. Or 4 years. And that was on my old computer. So basically, whenever I changed computers, that your intro and graphic
right.
went in the trash with my old computer.
With the way of the dodo.
With the day of the dodo.
All in number.
Yeah. Like you said, Pete. Oh, sorry, Gordon.
What's up, Colby?
So you made that, Slim?
No, I didn't. Pete did.
I did. It was when I first started doing call-in shows, which was probably the beginning of 2008. I started the YouTube channel in October of 2017. Mm-hmm. I started doing call-in shows maybe the summer of 2018. And so when I had frequent callers, and Slim was one of them. Slim was one of the first people to ever call into my show. He might have even been the first.
I see. Okay.
But anyway, so I had anybody who was a frequent caller, I had sort of an intro for, and that was that one.
Without an intro song.
And the ironic thing is, out of all those frequent callers that used to call and I used to have like intros for, Slim is the only one that's still here. Everyone else has abandoned me.
Yeah,
the last of the, I don't blame them, if you will.
I know. You said, someone bailed out. I know you said like in 2018, 2019, whatever. And then you promised me that you could, I probably can't right now, but maybe an intro. I don't know how you're going to do that, but
I don't know. Nobody has an intro anymore, Nate.
Yeah, I don't even do intros anymore.
I know, like you said.
But you promised him in 2018.
Damn it.
Hey, I want to ask you boys a question. How much did y'all spend on an engagement ring?
It's funny because when Uncle Lou and Battle Angel came down a few months ago to stay here with us, we went to the outlet malls. And we went into, I want to say it was like a K jeweler, it was whatever jewelry company it was. And we went in there and I look over and Mrs. Peete is talking to one of the salespeople and she's typing something in the computer. And I walk over there, I go, oh, she's about to buy something. So I had to go investigate.
Of course.
So I walk over there and I see my name on the screen and I see my wedding ring and her engagement ring on the screen. I go, what the hell? This was the place I bought it from. And now, when did we get engaged? We got married in 2007 and we were engaged for about a year and a half. So I guess we got engaged in 2006. Anyway, so this is how old this was. So she goes, oh, look, you get a free cleaning because, you know, you bought your engagement ring and your wedding ring from here. So she's like, you wanted me to clean it. I was like, sure. So I took my wedding band off. But anyway, the point is I had forgot how much I spent on the engagement ring and my wedding band until it was up on the screen. It had all the information, how much I paid for it, the date, the whole thing. And I paid. What was it, Mrs. Peete? I don't know if she's listening or not. I believe it was $1,600. Now, you got to realize, this is at a time I was 25 years old.
Right.
And so, needless to say, most 25-year-olds don't have a lot of money. Right? $1,500 or whatever, $1,600 was a lot of money to me. Mm. So that's how much I spent. That was based on the amount of money I was making at the time. I spent $1,600 on the engagement ring, and then my wedding band was like $600.
See, I was under the impression that the wedding band was more expensive than the engagement ring.
No. The engagement ring is
was news to me about like 5 days ago. I was like, what? That doesn't make sense to me.
It can, because some
and then
people
they want to
get
them branded together and everything.
Some people get wedding bands with diamonds in them, in which case, yeah, it will get more expensive.
Yeah, so that's what I have. And so, yeah, I'll show you mine. So, yes, but the engagement ring is supposed to be a big rock. It's definitely the most expensive thing that you're going to buy. My wedding band has diamonds in it. You can see here. And Mrs. Peete's wedding band also has diamonds in it. But her wedding band only cost a fraction of what the engagement ring cost. And here's the other thing, too. Do not spend more on your wedding band than you spend on hers. That's a no-no, bro. Don't do it.
What? Say that one more time.
Do not spend more on your own wedding band than you spend on hers.
Oh.
That's a no-no, bro.
To answer your question, Colby, it should be relative, at least in my opinion, to what you're making. You know, I mean, if you can't afford a fucking $10,000 ring, don't go out and buy a damn $10,000 ring.
Right, yeah, we're going up to Windsor tomorrow, and I'm looking to, like 5 to 7, but we also have, like a local guy that can do some stuff, too, that's going to be a lot cheaper.
I mean, now, you can take this with a grain of salt if you feel like it. Mm-hmm. That can also be a good test to see if she's a gold digger or not. Just saying.
I think you're onto something, Slim. Might have to have a discussion with her.
Well, because I spent around about the same what Peete did, maybe, you know, 100 or two less. But, I mean, back then, when I think I was right around, let's see, I was 24. You know, when I was 24, $1,400, $1,500 was a shit ton of money.
Yeah. Well, it still is. I mean,
yeah, well, I'm much more willing to drop a grand on something now than I was then.
I understand. But
see, we're going up to a place tomorrow called Windsor Jewelers in Augusta. It's one of the best places in the Southeast to buy jewelry, right?
Uh-huh.
And they're overpriced, and that's where my best friend got his engagement ring from. And then he went to his little broker that he's got, and he's like, yeah, I can get this for you, like, for half the price. Just not the little green box is what they call it.
Well, at the risk of getting Mrs. Colby or future Mrs. Colby mad at me, your first mistake is taking her shopping for the ring with you.
Yeah, you don't do that.
I didn't do that.
Well, the thing, she really wants to because I want.
Well, I know. Of course she does.
Boat. I'm on y'all's boat, okay? I want to pick it out, but it's like, it's not going to look good if you pick it out kind of bullshit.
Oh, look at C. Oh, no. Uh-oh.
So she just wants it to look like.
Uh-oh.
What?
SpaghettiO.
Am I going down the wrong road?
I'm just saying that red flags are abounding.
That's just, giant red flag. But here's the thing. Now, this is unique in itself because you are, like, in other words, most men propose without the woman's knowledge that they're going to propose. Right? Like, that's the reason, like Mrs. Peete had zero idea that I was going to be presenting her with a ring and asking her to marry me whenever it happened.
Yeah.
Did you ever hear the story about how I got engaged? This is the most tater man like engagement ever. It was on Christmas Day.
Uh-oh.
I'm sitting in the living room. We had just bought this house, this tiny little house, our first house. We're 25 years old. I'm sitting in the living room of this shoebox house, watching, of all things, college football. It's bowl season.
Right.
I tell Mrs. Peete, she's sitting there with me, or she's sitting in over on the other side of the room. I go, "Hey, woman, can you go get me a beer?" And she looked at me like, and I never talked to her like that, clearly. She's looked at me like, what did you just say to me? I go, "Hey, woman, can you go?" This was a test, by the way. I said, "Will you go get me a beer out of the fridge?" And she's like, "What, your legs don't work?" I'm like, "Woman, go get me a beer out of the fridge." Now, she's confused, but she does. She gets up. She walks into the kitchen. She opens the refrigerator. I had purposely only had one beer placed in there. So she had to grab that one beer. And guess what was on top of the beer?
The ring.
The ring. It was a test. If she didn't go get that beer, we might not be married right now. So she picks up the beer. She sees the ring. Now I had snuck up behind her and followed her into the kitchen. So she opens up the refrigerator. She sees the ring on top of the beer. She turns around and I'm on my knee and I ask her to marry me. So that's the most tater man engagement ever. It had everything involved. It had spousal abuse, college football, and beer. All involved.
That is
with a little misogyny sprinkled on top.
A little misogyny in there, yeah.
See, that's awesome. How I kind of want things to go. I want to do it in private like you did. I don't want all these public engagements. Like, I don't get off on that.
Yeah.
Yeah, the internet's full of enough people that look completely ridiculous getting turned down with public engagements.
Yeah, I did not.
You said, and you can give Mrs. Colby crap for this. She was like, "Hey, we should." Never mind. I'm not even going to say it's so bad.
She wanted to do it on somebody's live stream, didn't she?
No. It's way worse. I'm gonna text both of y'all and tell you what she thinks she wants.
But it is unusual. I mean, I guess it's not that unusual these days, especially that you plan the engagement together. But most of the time, it's a surprise.
Yeah, my wife had no clue it was coming.
Right.
Hey,
that's what I want, man. That's what I want.
Hey, could I do the same thing if I have, future?
Nate, take the walk before you run.
Yeah,
sir.
Start with the funeral first. Yeah, go to the
not what I meant, but okay.
Start with the funeral before the wedding, all right?
Why in the hell would I go to the funeral?
We already talked about this, Nate.
Do not pick up a girl at a funeral.
Why not? Slim did. He's married to it, and they have beautiful children together.
I'm about to say, I've been married for 10 years to it. Now, granted, we knew each other before the funeral.
Okay.
But
that's not important.
I've been to a funeral like once or twice.
I just want y'all to imagine Nate picking up a girl at a funeral. And think that's a good idea.
I think it's a fabulous idea.
You see like a freaking youth grandma that.
Well, there's nothing wrong with a sugar mama, Nate.
I don't want to marry a fucking grandma.
Nobody said you don't marry a sugar mama, Nate.
Oh.
Just get in the deed, get her money, you'll be all right.
So basically, I'm gonna be a spectator the whole time.
No.
Don't be a watcher. No one wants to be a watcher.
Or a
detector. Don't be like Dan Mullen when he's sitting in the corner while the team's running. Don't do that. It's not good.
I mean, here, let me count my matches real quick.
Oh, you got Tinder or something?
Yeah.
Yes, Nate's on Tinder.
Oh, Lord. God bless America.
Well, I blame America blame Tinder company because they invented it. So.
How many matches you got, Nate?
I know. Tinder. And I'm going to say their names. I'm just going to count how many matches I have.
Oh, you can say their names. We'll look them up.
Yeah. That sounds like a great idea.
Damn, they're hot.
Something tells me you say that about every single person on Tinder.
Did you match with the golf girl on Tinder?
No, Sally.
Oh, Paige Sporanic?
She's probably in California somewhere.
She's probably not on Tinder, Nate.
Probably not, yeah. Which is disappointing.
Something tells me she doesn't need online dating.
No, she definitely does not.
I bet she lies about her handicap, too.
Yeah, I don't know.
Ooh. Okay.
She might. Who cares?
there's Nicole, which just looks pretty good.
Man.
Emily, Taylor.
So hold on now, Nate. You've matched with these people?
Yeah.
So what's going on? I'm not in the dating pool, so I don't know anything about this. But what happens once you match? Does that give you the ability to speak with them?
Well, not speak with them, like text them for some reason.
Okay, so like direct message them.
Yeah.
So is that what you do, or?
Yeah, I wish you could call them, but eventually.
No, it's probably better that you text them first. Yeah.
Well, Nate, like Nicole, you just said you matched with Nicole. So what'd you say to Nicole?
Yeah.
I said, hey, how's it going? I said, she said, good. How about you? I'm good.
I said, wrong. That's where you're already messing up.
Oh, by the way.
Do not ever type to your first interaction with this woman should not be, hey, how you doing? All right. That's how you talk to one of your bros.
To be honest.
Like when you call into the show, I go, Nate, hey, how you doing? All right. No.
But. Good thing, because there's an automated direct message that's already ready for me, and it suggested me to say that, but it already was ready.
So forget the automated message. Listen to Pete. All right.
Okay.
Say hi.
The guys that dated in 30 years. Let's listen to him.
Hey, there's a reason. But hey, I'm not dating for a reason, bro. Yeah.
What's the advice, Pete?
My advice is don't ever, 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 ever have your first interaction with a woman, whether it's on Tinder or in real life, with hey, how you doing? Okay, just go right into the meat of the business.
Yeah, like, hey, baby. What's your name? What's your sign?
Yeah, no. The first thing you say to him.
That does not mean ask her if she wants to see your hammer.
Yeah, no.
No, I did not ask her.
You got to get right. You've got to come right out of the gate hot, Nate. This is the first thing you say to her. I saw your profile. I thought you were beautiful. I'd really like to get to know you better. Don't even say hi or how you doing or hi, I'm Nate. Forget all those pleasantries. That's bullshit. Women don't care about that.
Whatever Pigskin Peep just said, and then add, hey, do you want to get some coffee sometime?
Yeah.
Girls love coffee.
Yeah, they love coffee. Starbucks. Is there a Starbucks near you?
Do you want to get a coffee?
Yeah, there's Starbucks.
That's all you have to
say. Well, there's scooters.
Yeah, break out the credit card.
Are you talking about a day date, Colby? Because that's the express lane of the friend zone, sir.
Yeah, exactly. I agree with Slim on this one. No day dates. You're like, hey, baby. No, listen. You got to be way too big.
Plenty of times in awards.
You have to be a little bit chauvinistic, Nate.
We never don't ever get coffee.
Listen. You got to be way too busy during the day doing shit, being a man, to have anything to do with them. The only time you need to be messing around with that crap is after dark.
I'm not saying getting coffee. I'm saying that's your opening line. That's your opening line. You're not ever going to get fucking coffee. What the fuck? But that's what you want to hear. It's a good opening line.
Okay. So I take that you didn't get coffee then, Colby.
No, I got something else.
No, he probably got like some latte thing or something.
You got something better.
Something does tell me that Colby's coffee order is probably very similar to Pete and Lou's.
Right, so, it's got skinny in it and latte and all kinds of damn words.
I don't even drink coffee. That's the thing.
I challenge anybody to order from Starbucks and not sound like a sissy drink. I challenge you. That's the Pigskin Peete Starbucks challenge.
Hey, that's easy. You don't order from fucking Starbucks.
Well, right. Again, right.
I need someone to go into Starbucks and film themselves ordering at Starbucks.
I got a text from Uncle Lou at like 7:30 in the morning from the casino where I had just woke up. He goes, "Hey, Peete, I'm going down to Starbucks. Do you want something?" I didn't go to Starbucks. He asked me if I wanted something. I said, sure. So I told him what I wanted. I'm perfectly happy doing like I did today and drinking two cups of black coffee from my kitchen. But if somebody's going to Starbucks, then yeah. You know, when in Rome, you know the saying. Yeah, fuck a Roman.
That's words of advice right there. See, Nate, that's what you got to learn how to do.
Now, another piece of advice, Dave, if she sends you a message, minimum, absolute minimum, 2 hours before you respond to it.
Okay. So why do you have to wait 2 hours?
I mean, if they're interested, they're interested.
So why do you have to wait 2 hours? Why wait if you're...
Because
now, then.
Because they're going to spend the rest of... Listen, they're going to spend the rest of your life, if it actually works, you're going to be waiting at least 2 hours for everything that you ever go do. So you might as well at least start it off that way.
Yeah, that's great advice.
That wasn't my line of thinking. Okay. this is a broad statement. I'm probably going to piss off a lot of women, but I'm going to say
we know most of the audience is women.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Women are very... Women are much more, in my opinion, egotistical than men, and it hurts their ego if you are not responding to them immediately as if they're the center of your attention.
Okay.
So it intrigues them.
Yeah, keep them waiting.
Keep them pissed off.
Yeah, so, hey, Nate, here's some great advice from Victor.
You know, one is good, you know, two are better, you know.
You know,
and okay. then if you get three, well, that's just good business. So.
Now, if you can get that kind of business, either you have to do one of two things. Either make sure they know about each other from the beginning or they never find out about each other. One of the
friends that are girls. Although they're from Chicago.
Yeah, eliminate those.
About this story yet.
At this point in your life, Nate, whoever is in the friend zone, you need less friends. All right?
Yeah. I do have friends, but they're all boys.
I do tell
you.
You need a lot less friends.
Yeah, a lot less friends.
Nate, when he went to prom, did you see his prom date?
Oh, she was hot, man.
Oh, yeah.
Unfortunately, it was his cousin.
At least I'm not an Alabama fan. Nate,
you got to remember, you always got to, like, every New Year's, you got to offer up a cheers, man, to wives and girlfriends. Oh, may they never meet.
Yeah.
I don't know. I already gave Nate the blueprint to getting a date. He doesn't want to do it, you know, which I understand.
No.
I mean, it takes a special kind of person. Right, it takes a really horny guy like Slim to go pick up a girl at a funeral.
So,
but hey.
So, Pete, So have you actually done the things that you're telling Nate to do? Or
I have.
Yeah, me too.
I haven't. No, I haven't.
Done everything wrong you could ever possibly imagine in your life, VicTube.
I've never picked up a girl from a funeral.
Yeah.
I've only got one, Slim. Only got one of those.
Traveling Bulls has been on MySpace. That's how bad.
Man. Hey, Colby, you would have been one of my top eight friends, though.
So,
I appreciate that. Colby would have made the top eight on MySpace.
Yeah, he would have. All of you guys would have.
So, I might be the only human that's over 40 that never had a MySpace account, and I'm proud of that, too. I'll wear it like a badge of honor.
Hey, you have no idea how much. Dude, you had your own song. You had everything, dude. It was like fishing in a barrel.
I've heard that. Everything about
hey.
Great. I never have. So,
there's another girl named Taylor. That
is MySpace still a thing?
And like I said, there's a one, and there's a lot of automated messages, and one of them said, "What's the one movie that everyone wants to see in your opinion?"
Huh. So MySpace is still a site.
Slim Shady Canes is obviously Sandra Bullock.
Is that a good one or no?
Dude, what?
What?
Sandra Bullock.
Slim Shady Canes loves Sandra Bullock.
Negative, Ghost Rider.
Okay.
You know what her nickname is in the movie industry? What everybody call, like all the grips and everything? They call her Big Head Bullock.
Another
she's got this huge head.
Another girl named Dulce. I don't know how to name her. And she likes to work out, you know. Well, in her profile.
I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to sign up for MySpace and I'm going to start promoting it on every show. Like, go check out my MySpace account, everybody. It's a PigskinPeete. I don't even know if you can do that. Can you use like a fake name, like you can on Twitter?
Yeah. So do people still have MySpace?
Well,
MySpace is more MySpace. They kind of changed it. It's MySpace Music now. So
yeah,
just music.
Hey, yeah. I spent like about a year ago. It was during the plague. I was so bored that I didn't know what to do, and I spent like over an hour trying passwords, and I actually logged into my old MySpace, which was awesome. And it still had like the song, but it was awesome.
Was I logged back up.
Yeah,
it's like a time capsule. It was.
I actually logged back in, and I was like, I'm on my MySpace page.
All right. So what was your song then?
What was my song?
Yeah, what was your song?
Oh shit! Oh god, dang! I'd have to remember. I think it was Led Zeppelin, something Led Zeppelin.
Well, I'm on MySpace right now, and I have some bad news. I don't
think I've heard that song.
The Deftones have fired their lead guitarist. I'm sorry, everybody. Bad news.
I've never heard "Oh Shit" by Led Zeppelin, but
I want your guys' opinion on this message. If this is a mean message or not, I don't know. This is why I'm letting you guys decide. So it's an automated message that says, "Okay, doll. So I like this. I see you like to work out."
Oh,
Pause.
Wrong.
Okay.
Stop using automated messages, Nate, because everyone that you've read so far is worse than the last one you read.
Can I at least just finish it?
Go ahead.
No.
Go ahead.
Fuck it. It's
go ahead. Like to work out. Is it on? You are not getting a date by saying that.
Yeah. How do you know it's an automated message?
It just gives you a message and you can send it.
Yeah. Don't.
You get a drop down tab with like 10 questions you can just that generates randomly.
That's just sad. That's just sad.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say the best place to meet women is not on the internet. The best place to meet women is at a gas station. or at the grocery store, or
this is one of the few things I do agree with. Funeral. I think a bus stop is a good place to meet a chick.
A bus stop?
Yeah, she obviously needs a ride.
Okay, believe it or not, my mom and my stepdad met at a bus stop.
So I have heard Uncle Lou say the best place to meet women is at bus stops and bowling alleys. That is true.
Bowling alleys are so fucking useless.
Now, I'm not going to give Nate the same advice that I gave Ballard. I told Ballard, because it's a completely different situation, I told him just go hang out in front of your closest Planned Parenthood.
Oh, now that's a whole different story. You're not looking for a girlfriend there. That's just that's a different kind of date, bro. That you're looking for there.
Actually, I do have a friend that's with.
And that's
the chicks that are in there are guaranteed to put out.
Yeah, I know, but that's
okay.
That's desperation at its finest. Well, I don't think Nate's quite that desperate. Well maybe he is. I don't know.
I agree with you on that, but I'm going with it's a win-win all the time. Okay, you see that woman that gets out of her car and she's got that kid in the back seat or something like that. Okay, you can already go with the same philosophy. At a gas station, they're getting out to pump their gas. Dude, yeah, it's endless. You walk, chivalry's not dead. Hey, how you doing over there? You're way too good looking to be pumping your own gas.
Well, you're going
to
get this man
over there and you got a conversation going on.
You're
going
to get this man pepper sprayed.
No, you don't, Pete.
I have to disagree with that because I have been cussed out for opening a door for a woman.
Well, jeez. Oh, well,
let me guess, Karen. But
Slim, if that's the case, she's not in the men anyway. Trust me.
Exactly.
Yeah. So fuck it.
I get that. I'm just saying. I believe chivalry is dead.
But yeah. But traveling fool's advice is. But he's about to get Nate pepper sprayed. Imagine Nate comes over, and starts pumping your gas for you. She starts freaking out.
I never own a fucking car, so I don't know how I do that.
Well, then the bus station is actually a good idea.
Yeah. All right, go Greyhound, Nate. Greyhound.
But like hey,
boys,
I gotta
get
out of here.
All right,
Colby.
See you later, Colby.
Like I said, Miami
sucks. Like, what are they doing? Like, Miami fucking sucks.
Hey, we're in the tournament. Where's your sorry ass basketball team at? That's what I thought. Shut your face hole.
Yeah, this basketball time right now.
But yeah, I tried to do a bowling alley and didn't really work out. I don't know what's going on.
Now, Nate, have you tried
agree about the bowling alley because that's like the only thing there was in the town I lived in. So that was like the high school hangout spot was bowling alley.
Well, now I wonder, Nate, now you're a hockey player. Have you tried like the roller skating rink and the ice hockey rink?
Now you're thinking. I was about to say the same thing. You're reading. My great minds think alike.
Actually, there is hockey girls.
So Nate,
play hockey.
We've seen
hockey girls. I mean,
hockey like, girl. That's yeah, kind of like that's kind of like late. Like, that's kind of like Thailand lady boys.
They have like the night gig where they're roller derby girls. I mean, this is right up your alley.
This is great. This is great because you have to.
There's bound to be the chicks that hang out at the hockey rink, kind of like people call them badge bunnies, the chicks that go after any guy that's got a badge on.
Yeah, so, but Nate, you have to accentuate what you're good at, right? So, what are you good at? You're good at skating. And I've never seen you skate because I've only seen you in your basement, you know, knocking hockey pucks through the drywall. But I'm assuming that if you're good at hockey, you know, in your basement, that you probably can skate pretty good. So, this is a great idea by Traveling Fools. Yeah. Go to the skating rink. Right? And I'm not talking about for a hockey game. I'm talking about where they play music and you skate around and...
Oh, yeah, that's called open ice.
Yeah, okay, whatever. And...
Okay, Nate, when you hear that DJ come on there and he's like, okay, guys, now you know what time it is.
Yeah.
It's time for a couple skates.
Yes.
Couple skate. And you hear that and all of a sudden, you know, you hear Air Supply come on.
I don't think they're playing Air Supply anymore.
Oh, dude, I guarantee it's from Chicago. This is up in Michigan or Indiana or something. I guarantee that's on the radio. You reach out there.
No, not country roads, Nate.
And you take her out there on the couple skate and... Oh, dude, that's nothing drops panties faster than a couple skate.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then, so after you've spent whatever, an hour, you know, skating around, peacocking. That's what you're doing. You're peacocking. You're letting, you have to act like you don't care, first of all. Even though you do, we know you do, but you have to act like you don't. So you're skating around, you're skating backwards, you're doing the cross leg deal, you're showing off your skills, and believe me, there'll be women watching, even if you don't think they are, they're watching you. So you do that for a little while, and then like when Fool says, when they come over and they're like, okay, now it's time for the couple skate, you're this whole time, you're gonna have your eye, but not too obviously, because you don't want to be creepo, but you've had your eye on at least one or two or three girls the whole time you're skating. You just have to be like indiscriminate about it. So then you walk up to one of these fine ladies and they've been watching you skate backwards for the past hour. They're very, very impressed. And you say, would you like to skate? Now, they may say no. That's fine. Okay? Then you just go to the next one and ask her and so on and so forth. Eventually, even if it's for pity reasons, one of them will say yes. Okay.
I might do that.
Yeah.
There you go.
There you go.
And well, you got to make sure too. You got to act like you don't give a damn. During half the things leading up to this, you got to be over there eating some goddamn mozzarella sticks. You know, the fried ass things sitting over in the corner acting like.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and say Nate.
No, because then that gives. No, then that gives you like the where they want to nurture you at the same time.
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and say, Nate, refrain from eating around these women. We've seen you eat. It's not attractive.
No, I wouldn't do that.
Yeah, don't. Eat before you go or whatever you got to do. Just don't eat during don't eat at the skating rink. Now, if you want to buy her something to eat if she's hungry, that's fine. But you just refrain from eating.
Right.
All right.
Okay. All right.
If the skating rink doesn't work, then the funeral idea is a good backup. That's all I'm saying.
I might do that because I don't know if you mind to look up. Do you mind looking up the one of my ice rinks if you don't want to. There's one called Moylan Ice Rink. Or Iceplex.
What is it called?
I'll just spell it. M O Y L A N.
Moylan.
Ice rink.
Moylan. Okay. Moylan.
Yeah. Let's see what they got on there.
Yeah. Right? Moylan Iceplex, Omaha, Nebraska. Here we go.
Yep.
Okay.
I think they do have a schedule for that is called Open Skate or whatever, which is what you were talking about.
Here. For those of you on YouTube, you'll be able to see this fine establishment. Moylan Iceplex, here we go. And the first thing you see is a bunch of children. This is not a good place.
No.
This is a good. Okay. I'm liking it.
Go to schedule.
Go to schedule?
Want. Yeah, and
there's no schedule. You mean calendar?
Yeah, calendar. Man. Okay. Yeah.
I mean, look, right on the picture, you see a chunky blonde.
All right, so here we go. On March, what's today? The 24th. All right, so what do we got here? Today is Friday, so this has got to be a prime time. At 6:30 p.m. public skating.
Yeah, that's
it right there.
That's it. That's a perfect time for you too, Nate. From 6:30 to 10 p.m. That's prime time.
Yes.
Yeah, and they do play music, so.
Yeah.
And they do have boombox.
There you go.
And they have it tomorrow too, from 12:30 p.m. They got 6 hours of it tomorrow, Nate. From 12:30 p.m.
You don't want to go to the 12:30 though, Nate.
Well,
you want to go to like the 6:30, 7 o'clock at night.
I think the Friday night one's the best because that goes all the way till 10 p.m.
And they probably got like some music going at night with like the lighting, the mood lighting going and everything. And yeah, some Marvin Gaye is gonna come on at one point and stuff. I mean, dude, this is awesome. Hell, if I lived in Omaha, I'd take you.
Yeah. Good thing you don't.
Well, you too good to go skating with me, man? Come on. You'll hang out at the aircraft.
I meant weather-wise. I want a good place to live, but weather-wise, winter.
Well, I'll even do the couple skate with you.
Yeah, I would. I'd get out there, Nate. You know, we could skate around to some Chicago or Air Supply or something. You know.
Yeah.
Making love
out of nothing at all.
Crimson Brave says, don't take advice from random freaks on the internet. But we're not random freaks, though. I mean, freaks, maybe. Random, no. We know Nate.
Crimson Brave, best advice is not taking any
advice from random freaks.
Hey, but sometimes the best person to take advice from is a freak, man.
Yeah.
We know we know how to do, we know what's going on.
Yeah, we're experienced too.
Just saying that most of the time that what's it called? Free skate? Yeah, free skate.
It's called couple skate, Nate.
Most of the time
advice too, Nate. Don't take advice from somebody that shows up to an event and sits in the corner by themselves all weekend and doesn't talk to anybody.
Okay, just leave him alone.
I don't think he's giving anybody any advice, though.
No, that was just a free piece of advice.
Yeah, okay. I still think that VicTube has the best advice out of everybody.
Good, two are better,
And okay.
then if you get three, well, that's just good business.
That's the best advice I've ever heard.
Well, you know that is good business. It's like even with like the Mormons and stuff like that. You know,
this
like,
is good business.
Okay, you could listen to me, Nate. You could have one wife, okay, and that's a good thing. Now imagine having two. That's like the most miserable thing because they would constantly be fighting with each other. You have to at least go for three at that point,
right there.
Because
isn't that what Mormons believe? The reason they take so many wives is because they feel like if they go through hell on earth, then they'll go to heaven after in the afterlife.
Exactly.
You know what I think that is? Now that I think about it, with him saying three is just good business, I think VicTube has been listening to a whole lot of Andrew Tate here lately.
Oh Lord.
Well, I mean, it's possible. But I think he's a little bit innocent than me.
From the sounds of it, Vic's got more game than you, sir.
Well, I thought he's a virgin, so, which I am too.
Hey, don't mention that whenever you go to the skating rink.
No, yeah. I won't. Yeah. I won't.
Let's keep that to ourselves.
Some things are just better left unsaid.
Yeah.
Can you suggest pickup lines or?
The pickup lines, Nate. This is the problem. Pickup lines are not a thing.
Okay, well, whatever you say.
I believe it was Roger Dodger had the best advice, really, probably better than any advice I've given you and Vic's given you and Slim and everybody on Traveling Fools, Colby, everybody. He said, just be funny and be yourself. Now, I know that sounds very cliche and you're like, I am myself, but that's going to get you a lot further than whatever that generated message bullshit is. You know what? You look like you work out. If you tell a woman you look like you work out, she's never going to talk to you.
And by the way, I did not say that.
Okay. Nate, you know what? No. Let me say this. You know, the trick to it is keep them laughing.
Yeah, I mean, look at me. I'm just funny looking.
All you got to do is keep him laughing.
So I didn't even have to say anything. Mrs. Peete saw me. She said, he's funny. And I go, yeah, I am funny. She goes, no, you're funny looking. And here we are, 25 years later, married with two kids, because I'm funny looking.
Well, and I have to agree with Roger Dodger, because, I mean, speaking seriously, my wife's actually said that. She's like, that's something that attracted her was the fact that, you know, I'm going to be what I am. And if you like it, fine. If you don't. Fuck you.
No, I have a question for y'all. Just guess a number. I know you might say 11 or something, but
11.
The purple.
Like you said, eventually, right? But eventually, I went out of wife. Just guess how many kids would I have?
No, Nate. Lose that line of thought altogether. They will run for the hills if you even bring that up.
Hey, no. I'm used to kids because I have a job that I have.
Oh, my God.
Well, that's fine. So is my wife because her brother's got 10 of them. But that was not a conversation you had.
Well, I'm just asking in general and for fun. I mean.
Okay, Nate, my guess would be 17.
Nate, here's another way to get a woman. You see what I'm wearing right now?
No.
Do you own a shirt like this?
Don't dress like that, Nate.
Nate, do you own a shirt that looks like this?
A tater man? No.
No. If you,
I've probably got 20 of those.
It's basically a license to, I mean, it's a good thing. Mrs. P has to basically keep you locked in the house, because if I walk out of the house wearing this shirt, it's over. You know what I'm saying? Lawyers are being called. There's custody battles going on, bro. You know what I'm saying? So get you a shirt like that.
Miami fans are fucking delusional. Jesus Christ.
No, you have to be the eternal tourist.
Cheesy pickup lines, especially ones that are funny, are good icebreakers.
No, unless you want
to. Yeah, are your feet tired? Because you've been walking through my mind all day, or running through my mind all day.
No, you know one of the best ones that I ever had, and this actually worked, and it started out as a goofy challenge, but we would walk up to these girls in these bars, and we'd walk up and be like, "Hey, my name's Brennan, and I'm unattractive."
Nope.
And that was the icebreaker. And they'd look at you and stop, and then they'd start giggling and be like, "What the fuck are you even talking about?" And from then on, it was easy pickings, man.
I'm trying to find a good.
That kind of goes back to Roger Dodger's point: is if it gets them laughing,
keep them laughing.
That's all you got to do.
Keep them laughing. That's all you got to do is keep them. Because if they're laughing, they're smiling. If they're smiling, they're having fun. Just keep them laughing.
Luke says, "Did you fall from heaven? Because boy, your face is messed up."
God damn. I love that one.
That's a great one.
You could pull that on like a hot ass chick, man, and fucking. Oh man, you'd be
never. I would never tell that to a girl. Never.
Like I pulled waitress, Nate. If just go up and ask her for a number, and the standard line is that she's got a boyfriend, that's what she's going to say. And your response to that needs to be that you have a math test. No, your response to that is you have a math test. When she asks you what a math test has to do with it, tell her you thought we were talking about things that we can cheat on.
I thought I could ask, like, do you think the earth is flat?
No, don't go down the flat earth.
Hey, listen, don't ask them that. But if they bring it up, here's the other thing. Any man knows this, especially if you're looking for a woman. It doesn't matter whether you have interest in it or not, or whether you believe it. As a matter of fact, the crazier the conspiracy theorist she is, probably the better, honestly. Like, if she's like, look, if she's like that chick that I play on here, the Jenny Rose girl.
I'm pretty sure we'd all go for whatever she has to say.
Exactly. If she starts talking about, well, maybe she's a little bit crazy, which is fine. All women are crazy, Nate. I mean, and I hate to break the news to you, but all women are a little crazy. If she starts going, well, you know what? I will go out with you, but I need to know this about you first, Nate. She goes, do you believe that the earth is a globe, or do you think it's flat? Whatever she believes, you believe. Okay. Yeah. Whatever it is, whatever crazy thing she believes in, you believe in it too.
Yep.
Even if you don't believe it.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. Y'all can plan a trip to the fucking ice wall if you have to. But
Hey, Pete. I've had some inspiration. I think as a way to gather more followers on the internet, me, you, and Fools need to start doing like a dating advice podcast.
Oh, just awesome. Well, this would be a hell of a segment.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll be the special guest every day.
Well, yeah, we could try it as a segment to see if it takes off, and then when it does, we'll all become, you know, podcast billionaires.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
Remember on TK.
Imagine the Twitter the outrage we could gain from our dating advice. So if you haven't introduced her to the donkey punch by the third date, you need to cash in on the next one.
Both and hoes. Oh, sorry. You guys remember the TK stream like on Wednesday? I think Wednesday night. Where I talked about my cast, since I know we're talking about girls and advices and stuff, but just a little bit off course, and we can go back to, you know.
A little bit?
Nate, can you see the screen right now?
No.
There isn't a single...
You talking.
There isn't a single man alive that this woman has ever talked to that believes that, that anything that she says about the flat earth. Not a single one of them, but they pretend like they do. You see what I'm saying?
Why does this girl look so much better live than she does right here? Because she looks like she... Jesus Christ, her head looks like a fucking egg. Like she looks horrible in every one of these pictures. I mean, that's...
You mean Humpty Dumpty?
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and disagree with you on that.
I mean, no, dude. She looks like a fucking... No, and you scroll on down. Okay, now we're getting to some that look okay. But, oh, yeah, the one in the middle there moving. That's...
I remember a video that she farted live.
What? Yeah. I have that, actually. Yeah, she did. She let one rip. Yeah. Mrs. Peete, that's for scientific research only. I did not, don't get mad at me. Let me see if I can find that.
Exactly, Nature Boy filters. That's a lot of filters right there.
Can I get some mods?
You've said that.
I'm getting the ears today.
Oops.
And I'm just going to throw it out there.
I'm getting irritated.
And I've had this conversation.
School taught us literally nothing. Waste of 13 years.
What?
I was just going to address this real quick. You've said that now several times. And I've actually had this conversation with my wife. And I told her she's a lying sack of you-know-what if she tries to say that she doesn't window shop, too. So don't get mad at me for doing it.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's just part of being married for so long and being together for so long. I don't hide the fact that I mean, look, people, anybody who pretends like they're not looking at the opposite sex, they're lying to themselves and each other. Of course, everybody does that.
And any woman is going to get mad. You know what? If a woman wants to date, like, I mean, every woman wants a man, and every man knows. I mean, if you see a big old set of chi-chis walking by and your eyes don't look at it, then your woman probably should be more worried.
Yeah, exactly.
Than if you are looking.
So Mrs. Peete does this thing. It's I don't know what it's like, boot camp, you know, some shit that she pays for and goes and does like a boot camp workout thing every day. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So anyway, so it's a male instructor, and she came home and told me. She's like, it's really hard to get through the hour. It's really hard. You know, I want to give up. She goes, but the guy gets in my face and he starts encouraging me and he's really hot. So I do it because of that. I go, whatever. Yeah, cool. You know what I mean? He's really hot and he's encouraging you to be in shape. I'm all for it, bro. You know what I mean? I don't care.
I gotta say, Peete, it's the same way that Mrs. Fools has been going to this new dentist. And he's like this 27-year-old, you know, young dentist. And he's like, well, yeah, I'll just like that'll be $60. That'll be $50. All this shit. I'm like, what are you doing, flirting with the fucking dentist?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The hot dentist. That's another one.
At the same time, I'm like, well,
yeah.
Hot dentist.
I mean, listen. As long as he doesn't eat my steak in the freezer or drink my whiskey, as long as the motherfucker's gone before I get there.
That's a stinger right there.
Yeah. That's a good stinger. Yeah, yeah. If he drinks my last beer, we got problems.
Right.
Yeah.
That's a stinger right there.
God damn, that's funny.
See, Nate.
Fucking. Nobody listens to my point.
That's a good stinger. I don't even know why I didn't think of that before. She's getting mad. She goes, nobody listens to my points. Yeah, that's been a problem probably your whole life, honey.
But
nobody listens to my point. This is why girls like don't like men. Going to
this is why girls don't like men.
Well, that's it can't be true if you're a lesbian.
Jesus,
we
Nate.
School, we all learn the same thing. Some of us are smart enough to look deeper than the surface. Thanks.
She's smart. She's smarter than you are, Nate. And me. And Slim.
She is probably pretty intelligent, though.
It's a lot.
Put out sounds a like, a, sounds like she's talking to her therapist, not fucking doing a live stream.
Boobs that big being dumb.
No, not at all.
I'm going to wait for whatever happens. And I'm... I don't know.
Wait for I've got so many
low vibrational
Somebody just said she's got a really big forehead. What forehead? What are you talking about?
I got a big forehead. You mean this chick's got a head?
I don't think I've ever seen her forehead before.
I didn't know there was anything above her shoulders.
I have a big forehead. I think I do.
Oh, man. Now, she reminds me of this girl. Like, you ever have, like, that like, friend of yours who has a sister and just, like, smoking hot and...
Yeah.
And then... I had this buddy of mine, good friend of mine, and his sister was just like, I mean, unbelievable. She was actually in Maxim magazine, and we ended up one night, hooking up, doing this whole thing. And the funniest thing about it was with the lights dimmed and everything like that, she looked just like her brother. And I was like, this is horrible.
Oh, somebody just asked. I forgot the whole reason I started that video. Yeah, the fart. Let me just fast forward to it. I can't listen to her. Let's see where. I'll find the fart for you. I think it's when she knocks over the camera.
I'm good at tuning shit out.
Yeah, here we go.
So, and my phone's fucking charging, so I can't set it.
Hold on, I don't know that. I don't know the exact moment where she farts.
I died. So. And my phone.
Damn it.
And at least she's pretty, and I would rather them say those other stupid ass comments they make. Like, don't you know? Like, I don't even know. Anything but that.
I think this is the video where she goes, blah, 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 or whatever.
What I'm saying is that school is teaching a lie. So you telling me to go to school is telling me to go learn the lie that I am trying to counter.
So her logic here is telling me to go learn in school is stupid.
Died.
That's what she's saying.
So
God damn it.
She might be onto something there, though.
Well, except when it comes to, you know, except when it comes to like physics and things like that. I mean, that kind of is important. I understand what your point is. Yeah, but you're talking more about social stuff, not, you know. E equals MC squared. I mean, I think you probably need to go to school to learn physics. I don't think you can do it on the internet.
I would rather them say those other stupid ass comments they make.
Do you need to go to school to learn history?
Don't you know? Like, I don't even know. Anything but that.
Where in the hell is the fart? I know.
About the lack of our education.
Yeah. Yeah, speaking of physics, where's the fart?
Yeah.
Is there one with a video that involves a trampoline?
I don't know if there's a trampoline video.
Shit that you would pay a webcamer to do, I'm blocking you.
Oh, look.
I don't want men on here. I don't want perverted men on here.
She says I don't want perverted men on here, and she's prancing around in a bikini 24 hours a day.
Hey. I have no desire to talk to you. I wish I could just filter all of them out. I want to talk to people
that's as bad as those porn stars.
She wants to talk to. Did you hear that?
Women as sex objects.
No.
She wants to talk to people who are high vibrational. Is what she said.
You know what though? I would venture out to say she's probably a lot more intelligent than we're giving her credit for.
Yeah, I don't think she's stupid.
I'll bet this is all. I mean, how many views is she getting? How many? You could be really smart doing this right here, putting on this act, and getting all these viewers and making a living.
Yeah, I don't think that the flat earth thing is an act, though. I really don't.
It might be, though, man.
I really don't think it is.
I pretend to be a flat earther a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, my tits ain't that big. So
I don't know. I can tell you, she definitely believes the earth's flat. Yeah. And she, and the reason I know is because she gets genuinely mad at people when they. Yeah, it's not an act.
Huh? I mean, fools has got a point, though. I mean, but now, if you're not making as much money, you got to venture over to OnlyFans or Dad Bods and Small Rods are making a comeback.
Yeah.
People that are high vibrational. I didn't ask you to be
What
here.
Is she doing to the straw right there? I don't know how many of you guys can see this, but what is she doing?
I need to know the definition of
this video.
Person.
I don't know, but this video gets more interesting the more I watch it. But what is she doing there?
I wish I could just filter all of them out. I want to
is
talk
she chewing
to
the straw?
People.
She's like sticking her finger in it.
High vibrational.
That's disgusting.
I didn't ask you to be here. I don't want you here.
I think she might be wiping lipstick off of it, which is counterproductive because she's got. Oh.
Like, that's not. Like, I'm not even getting paid for this. Like, don't ask me to do shit like that. You can Venmo me $500 and then I'll take a picture. My Venmo's JR.
There she goes.
There it is. Ding, 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 ding.
I'm telling you, she's on to something.
Spread the truth. We get the knowledge. We spread the knowledge.
I'm still waiting on the fart. On it.
And then you're going to get your people, a lot of people, people don't know how many people like me are out there, flat earthers. A lot of people don't have any idea, but they're afraid to talk about it because they don't want to get made fun of. This, you can only like do this if you have confidence. Like, you cannot be doing this if you don't have thick skin, because like everyone's going to hate you.
He's got some pretty thick skin up front.
And you can't care.
Thick something.
The reason like that what will get you to be able to do this is deep inside. Like, if you just know in your soul knows, the then you're fine.
Yeah, if you just know in your soul that the earth is flat, you'll be fine.
First video, I literally,
I mean, forget science, just as long as you know in your soul.
I wasn't 100%.
Hey, she's got a point, my though. I'm so afraid wasn't that what it the is government now. May find out.
So I was still kind of like, I feel like I'm going to get all this hate. But then when I had the spiritual awakening, and now...
She had a spiritual awakening.
I laugh at you.
And she laughs at you. Now, nothing.
Talk about the whole flat earth thing, though, Pete. I've been going down this rabbit hole into that, man. It there's a lot of sense to be made with it, man.
Where's the fuck?
I don't even know where to begin with that. I don't even know where to begin with it. Did you have a spiritual awakening?
Did we have the Slob Olympics at the hospital?
I mean, why is Antarctica? I mean, why don't they even put it on the map? Why does it surround the?
Because they don't care about it. Because
it is on the map. What are you talking about? Of course, it's on the map.
Well, no, it's always on the map, but it's on the bottom and it surrounds everything. Yeah, why is it on the old maps and not on the new ones?
What?
Oh yeah, you gotta look into this.
From the new maps. Yeah. Exactly. Like, Antarctica's not on Google Earth. They took it off.
It's all blurred.
Because they want they want to expose the mysteries of it.
Okay, going back to this video, she just said that she laughs at us. She said, I laugh at you, which I'm assuming is me because I'm laughing at her. But nothing. Let me give you a piece of advice, women. Now, I'm probably the last person that women should be taking advice from because I'm clearly not a woman. But from a man's perspective, if you're hot, which some people say she has a big forehead, I think she's hot, okay? If you're hot, don't go on the internet and tell other people that you laugh at them. Okay? Yeah. That is the most, that's the biggest turnoff. Like if a hot girl who knows she's hot and starts looking down on other people because they're not, is very unattractive. All right. Now,
I laugh at them.
Especially when she farts.
I laugh at all these little whatever. They're probably paid by the government. Like, I don't care about
paid by the government.
I didn't ask for it. Post your videos, I'll post mine. And this is the thing, like, people are like, oh, dude, you put the rose in your mouth. Sorry. Literally talking about the ocean is the container and the earth is a ball and a ball. It's not flat. Like, you're stupid as hell. And then you're saying the oceans don't lay flat. Okay, cool, dude. Cool. Get a haircut or something.
Yeah, what?
I just can't deal with it.
Get a haircut.
It's like,
now, I have a question. How flat are we talking? Are we talking thin crust? Are we talking hand tossed? Are we talking deep dish?
I don't know.
I mean,
what kind of comeback is that? Get a haircut. I laugh at you. Get a haircut. This is really. Go ahead. What were you saying?
I was just saying that this is what Nate needs to be going after right here.
Yes.
Because you know what, Nate? I would be jealous of you.
Yeah.
I mean,
everybody knows that crazy women are good in bed. So she's probably.
There must be some benefits to society from Nate dating this chick.
Because I think about it. Forget the funeral home. Hang outside of a psychiatrist's office. Yeah, get a crazy one.
I am posting my thoughts. I am posting my knowledge, and I'm trying to reach the truth, okay? And that's what I'm doing.
Yeah.
What are you doing? You're taking other people's videos, not tagging them, using them for views,
oh, no.
And making fun of their beliefs.
Oh, shit. She's talking to me.
Is that not the most negative, low vibrational thing I've ever seen in my life?
Yes.
Hey, like, Pete,
I'm barely vibrating at all. Jenny Rose. She's right. I'm very low vibrational. I haven't vibrated all day.
Routine, and then you can come talk to me. It's rude. Like, your entire persona is making fun of people's beliefs.
Yeah.
What am I doing?
I'm posting my thoughts and my feelings and my knowledge and my spiritual connection. That's what yeah. I'm posting. And
yeah,
I'm
we've seen your spiritual connection, all right. It's all over TikTok.
For it. Okay.
There's two of them. Two spiritual connections.
Tell me why it's a
glow. There's probably been some spiritual connections all over a picture of her.
All you can say is, oh, go to put a candle. Go put a candle. What are you talking about?
What is she talking about? Go put a candle.
This actual dumbass. And then he's going to call me a dumbass. Like.
She scares gold. Where's the fart, though? How do they.
Oh my god, she skipped school.
It's the dumbest comment.
I would rather them say at least she's pretty. And
I think we just listened to that whole thing. I didn't hear the fart once.
Like, don't you know? Like, I don't even know anything but that.
That's behind the paywall.
It just makes no sense, because what I'm saying is that school is teaching a lie. So you telling me to go to school is telling me to go learn the lie that I am trying to counter. My ring light died.
Here it is.
So. And my phone.
Damn it.
Fucking.
I thought that was it.
Charging, so I can't set it to stay where the fuck it's at.
I am OCD. Oh, there it is. Hey, there we go. I'm not ending the show until I hear it. For all of you who've been waiting, here you go. You're welcome.
Charging, so I can't set it to stay where the fuck it's at.
Now, clearly, she's not farting. But it does sound like that, though.
So I can't set it to stay where the fuck it's at.
They think that's funny.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, I got a bounce.
Yeah.
But I've got a treat for you tonight, Pete.
Okay.
I've got some sound bites that you're gonna love to hear. So, yeah, you're gonna like this. So,
okay,
be ready.
All right, good. I will be. Thanks for the warning. I guess.
All right, guys. You have a great day, but Pete, get ready. I've got some sound bites for you tonight that you're gonna absolutely love. So, just get ready.
All right. I'm ready. See you later, fools. Right. Have a good one.
Peace out, guys.
All right, Nate, I got to bounce too, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
And thanks for having me on, though.
Yes, of course. And seriously, Nate, don't anything that we said today, as far as giving you advice on dating or anything in life, do not do it. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Love you, Pete. See y'all.
Oh,
this was a good one.
This was a good one. It was a 3-hour show. 3-hour midday morning show. Say that three times fast.
Right. Now, I was actually kind of half serious about the dating advice podcast.
Yeah.
So if there's anybody left watching this, if there are topics y'all would like to see covered, put them in the comments section after this video is over.
Yes.
And we'll go back, and if there's enough of them, I'm sure me, Pete, and Fools can get together and actually make a video answering your dating advice questions.
Yeah, dating advice podcast from three guys who aren't dating. That's a great idea. I actually like that.
Well, it is a great idea because all three of us are married, and that's why we're not dating. So
okay, well,
obviously we're masters.
You bring up a good point, my friend. All right, Slim, it was good. Thanks for coming on. I had a lot of fun. Appreciate you.
Yes, everybody.
All right, have a good day. Wow. Wow. Well, that one, I think this episode will go down in the history books as one of the greatest midday shows that 40 people watched. I mean, it's going to go in the museum. But seriously, thanks to all of you. Some of you may have came in late, and you're probably wondering, why is he ending the show at 11 o'clock, and the show doesn't start till 11 o'clock? Well, I started the show at, about a quarter till 9 this morning. Since Uncle Lou wasn't doing his morning show, I decided to start the show a lot earlier, and so it's actually been a few hours. But I will be back tonight at 10 p.m. for the live call-in show, so I hope you all join me then. Thanks for all the people that came in, commented, to hit the thumbs up, all that good stuff. I appreciate you. Have a great Friday, and I'll see you soon. Your boy is checking.